places with no place left to go. Without you within me, I can't find no rest. Where I'm going is anybody's guess. I try. Tell me I should carry on, but I am swimming in an ocean all alone. Baby, my baby, it's written on your face. You still wonder if we made.
Real talk is all about fun, it's all about entertainment. It's just what's real and not what's ideal. Now that's the effect of Real Talk on a Monday night from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
Good night everybody out there in Radio Land, and welcome one more night to Real Talk, the show where we discuss everything real and nothing ideal. Tonight, I hope that we can bring you as much laughter as you heard from Chris McKenzie. Despite all the challenges and the fears and the tears and the sad moments that some people might be going through tonight, let me just first of all send our condolences from Real Talk, our condolences to the family of the late Ramon Forbes, young, vibrant, promising young man who passed away tragically in a plane crash last week. I'm sure the family must be going through pain and heartache, and they're feeling quite incomplete tonight without their son. To his mom, she's a teacher at the Fair Prospect Primary School. We hope and pray that the Lord will keep you and guide you through. Also to his father, who works at the Port Antonio Health center. Our deepest, deepest condolence to you from the family of Styles FM Radio. And also to Laverne Harvey from Sherwood Forest. She also is a young lady who has a business place in the Prospect area of Port Antonio. She also lost her life tragically last week. And of course, condolences go out as well to you, to her, and her immediate family and friends. To the Teachfield family, of which Raman was a part, our condolences to you as well. And we pray that the Lord will give you strength and guidance as you try to understand it all. All right. On a sad note tonight, we started, but in the midst of life, we know that there is death. And of course, we're going to try our best to see how best we can cheer up your spirits tonight here on Real Talk. Daddy Rude, how are you doing?
I never feel so injured now, but you know, things set already.
Yeah, I know, I know.
I feel, you know, a little bit tired now. I'm going to get a little rest, but...
Didn't.
Not tonight.
Hush, no rest for the weary.
You look like... you look like a little gangster girl tonight.
Gangster for life! Yeah. You know, that was a feeling I had today.
Yeah.
So last week, was it, or week before, I was feeling militant.
Yeah.
Is it the opposite? No, not really. Team. Yeah, and the same theme going on. Yeah. So, of course, our engineer tonight is none other than the Silent Assassin, and the name fits my look tonight. Yeah.
No.
Gangster, assassin, yeah. Silent Assassin. The photographer, that is.
He
gave me a look. Okay. He's the photographer and our engineer tonight, Cassidy. Yep. And, of course, on my right is my tired and crazy, full 100 crazy co-host, Daddy Rude. And you know, the lady in the middle, of course, is sane. Very, very sane. I can't overemphasize sane. Lady Cleo. Yes. Welcome to you guys on the World Wide Web. All those listening in tonight on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. All of you guys, those on the WhatsApp line who will be texting us later on in the show, welcome to you and big ups for your large. You can't large no more because you keep it locked every single Monday night to Real Talk. And even if you don't text in or call in or get the chance to listen every Monday night, but you do on most occasions, we big you up just the same. First timers, you're most welcome. And nice to have you on board, Real Talk. All our friends here in Portland, Jamaica. All our friends in St. Mary, St. Anne. St. Thomas. All across the length and breadth of this beautiful island of Jamaica. Welcome to Real Talk. I'm feeling hot. Yeah. Is it me going through early something? I won't call that word. No. Is it me going through something early? Or is it Cassidy that hasn't turned the AC on? Because I cannot take off all my clothes up in here.
No, I beg you not. I beg you not to. Please don't.
That's what the song says.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So we can't afford that now. Sure. So,
you know, one other thing that I'd like to share with persons, because, you know, we have a sponsor, hardware sponsor.
Mm-hmm. Hardware. Interesting. I like that.
Which is Builders Depot.
Well, I got you to smile now, didn't I?
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, they have a special, and I'm just knowing that a couple of, about half an hour ago.
Alrighty.
And it's really interesting. I'm Mr. Boy Moden. Without any hesitation, more of a share this with the listeners, them.
Mm-hmm.
That for persons that are getting their loan with the National Housing Trust, they actually do special discount for NHT finance projects.
Okay, interesting.
And whenever you find something like that, you can't, and I can urge people, you can't make them something pass, because anything, especially if you do with home construction,
mm-hmm,
you can get some amount of cost cuts.
Trust me, you need to grab it.
Utilize it.
Yep.
All right, so that's Builders Depot. They actually have special discount for NHT finance projects. So check them out, people who are planning their home construction.
Yep.
That's the place to go, Builders Depot.
Yep. All righty, so there you have it. So how have you been?
It was a very hectic weekend. We just wrapped up the last photos cast for the calendar.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, so I've been on the road. I came to Portland on Saturday. I came to Portland Sunday.
Ooh.
And I'm now in Portland today.
So that sounds like you left.
I left last night, yes.
So the 3 days that you were here, you had to leave and come back?
Yes.
Wow. That's a lot of traveling.
Yep. So, and I was scheduled to be in Trelawney tomorrow.
Ooh.
And then I was scheduled to be in Kingston on Wednesday.
You travel very regular? Very regular?
In Jamaica.
Well, I have been fortunate to be in the parish. I'm a little busy myself this week, but I was here yesterday and the day before. And today, I'm here again.
Again, or still.
Still, right.
So, tell me something. What you cook yesterday?
Oxtail.
But do you remember there's something we read about the amount of cholesterol?
Don't even bother to go there, because to all me, they forget where you read. You just feel the oxtail, and me just look about oxtail.
Okay.
So me don't want no reminder.
I got rabbits yesterday. My brother, he's a rabbit. He's into rabbit farming.
You just called your brother a rabbit on radio?
But if I did,
you which know, other brother is that?
Well, if I did, you know that rabbit does that thing that quite frequent.
Don't tell me about it. I want some rabbit meat sometime soon, please.
Yes.
Thank you. I've had it once, long ago.
Then you say, what do you mean?
And I want duck.
Kill me dead. A chicken. I'm going to tell me, say, boy, no.
I want duck too. Anybody who have duck?
No, but I know something that rhymes with it that you can get that in abundance.
Deliverance. I pray. Gracie, I pray for my co-host tonight.
What?
I also need turtle. I guess they're endangered-ish.
Mock.
You know what? Let me big up and, of course, See me out an idiot. Let's big up Taria. Barber shop.
Taria, where are you dealing, man?
Yes, Taria, quite so. True menopause. I can't R&B barber shop in UK telling me I'm going through menopause. You see why we women can't take you men?
Because
it's all about you. You bring misery to our lives. Menopause, menstruation,
and menopause.
Mental breakdown. Oh my goodness. Oh, can I tell you? Let me give you those numbers to hook us up, and of course those numbers for the undergo.
What about many money?
There's no such word as many money.
I just did.
I told you it was a Looney Tune, didn't I?
So don't
all right.
Like many money.
That's not men. Just money is a different word. There's no men in money.
Many money.
Moving right along.
I mean, N and I.
Oh, jeez. the on-the-go numbers for the USA, Canada, and the UK. The USA on-the-go number, if it is that you want to listen to us while you're on the go, in the USA, that number is 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. In the UK, it's 033-001-033-22. That's 033-001-033-22. And if you are in Canada, which is very cold, you know, I hear, it's 647-957-9637. 647-957-9637. And we have other numbers that you can call us directly. The number for the local line right here at Yard in Jamaica, that number is 453-1444. That's 453-1444. And that's the same number for the WhatsApp, all right? And if you are overseas in foreign land and you want to call a yard to talk about what we're discussing tonight or to have your input, that number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. Cool. All right. And big ups again to our friends, of course, on the 96.3 FM in Brooklyn and the 102.9 FM in the Bronx. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Fridays, and Saturdays. All right. You can tune in. All righty. So, we are about to kickstart.
Let me ask you a question.
The show in a few.
Let me ask you a question, because tonight's show is going to be about primarily, how should I put it? Tonight's show is going to be primarily about...
You're up to no good.
I'm up to good.
You're up to good. Okay.
I'm up to good. More, I just want more find on big word.
Oh, boy.
I just want to find like a normal, regular...
Ordinary word. You want to coin your own word right now? Like, add your word to the vocabulary, to the English vocabulary?
Tonight's show will be about... I'm trying to find a nice big word. It's about bun, right?
Bun?
Bun, yeah.
Infidelity.
I didn't want to use that word.
Bunism?
Because infidelity speaks to...
Bonoration?
I think. Bonarism.
Bonarism. Okay, then.
Well, bonarism.
I am not going to allow you to turn me into an idiot tonight. I swear it. Okay?
I think primarily that's what it's about. I think it appears as if that's what's been in the air.
Really?
It's Christmas time. It's all called, it makes sense.
No, it's supposed to be for Easter. You give bun at Easter time. Christmas time is about turkey and duck and rabbits.
What, and what rhymes with duck?
Rabbit.
Okay. Truck.
Yes, truck.
Right. Pluck.
And I'm going to pluck you if you don't start the show tonight and behave yourself.
So, since last couple of weeks, there has been a number of incidents upon incidents upon incidents. So, I think it's quite appropriate for us to once and for all, and I know that once and for all is going to be repeated so many times as it relates to who does what, who does it best, and blah, blah, yada, yada. But let me ask you a question. Do you really and truly believe that women are better at cheating than men? And why?
Actually, I don't believe that women are better at it. No.
Explain.
I think men... Well, better in some regard, maybe. But I think men are the ones who just repeatedly just do this thing as if it's a natural part of them.
That doesn't mean that we're better at it.
But if you master the art of it like that, then automatically you become, quote-unquote, better. I mean,
we might be better at discarding or
concealing or, you know, camouflaging, whatever. But generally speaking, I think you men are better at it. You lie blatantly. A woman might have to feel or think hard to try to bring across a lie effectively. You men just lie to the skin of your teeth. It's like nothing to lie.
So would you want the truth?
How about not doing certain things? We want that. Just don't bother to do certain things.
Like what?
That you know will create a problem where if we hear the truth, it's going to be effective.
Yeah, but that can be...
So just don't bother to do certain things.
That can be arranged.
You men will get a call from one of your females, and you're trying to play it off as if, oh, you're brethren. And we know from the way you answer the phone, and you started to talk, we know say are some catia call. Yeah? You cannot hide that so easily.
Well, let me ask you a question.
Or you're moving, you're gone somewhere else.
Well, let me ask a question. What would you prefer to call us? A catty or the opposite, which rhymes with catty?
Opposite.
No, burn up, burn up that, burn up that. You know, ladies and germs, it is now 9:30.
I want to call you a cat. The other word for cat
is rat.
No, the other synonym for cat.
Hat.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Yeah. It's now 9:30.
The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And Real Talk is sponsored by Builders Depot. Remember that Builders Depot have a special discount for NHT financed projects. And also sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. So forward.
Yep.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
This feeling is taking over me. I'm so excited.
Feel the euphoria.
Tuesdays from 5 to 9 p.m. with the master mixer musical maestro Digital T.
Giving a total satisfaction with melodies and memories by the score. With the widest selection of genres and hits. So you don't know the program you turn up, you know. So you know politics are full ass, the one you want to slap with.
Digital and we are party. Yeah, we flawless. Euphoria the program every Tuesday.
5 to 9. Every Tuesday.
With the musical maestro Digital T.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, we're perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Good morning, Heavenly Father.
5 a.m., the Lord's Hour, on Styles FM 96.1 and 96.7. Tune in to be blessed and inspired by the Word of God and uplifting gospel music. Start your day right. Start it with the Lord's Hour.
Planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Welcome back, guys, to Real Talk. And, of course, you're listening to Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude.
So, as I was
asking, which of us...
No.
You asked which, whether it was a man or the woman.
No.
Let me hear it.
Me pass this. I was at the point when I was asking you the question.
Mm-hmm.
What exactly do you want to hear?
The truth or a lie?
Yeah.
Boy, me tell you, I know, because certain truths hard to swallow. Me not lie. But give it to me.
Because, you know...
Don't lie to me.
Quite a bit.
Can't manage your lying still.
Quite a bit.
I'm going to believe you lie and it not going to work.
Quite a bit of discussion been happening. And the females are saying, say, boy, why, like we are saying, man told lion. Why was this? I want to know when we are tell lie. And sit down, cow fat and all kind of crap. I'm going to say, what exactly do you want? Do you want the truth? Can you deal with the truth? Can you deal with blah, blah? I said, boy, I'm not sure, yes, but tell me, like, what you say, exact thing. So, you see, there's just one, what you call it now, one original, which is Eve, and all on our blueprints, all on the same thing, you know?
Just like all you men are the same thing?
Nope.
You're all, it's one Adam. Well, all on the same thing, too.
There was the devil.
Which is one in the same for Adam.
No, he was him.
Yeah.
No.
But I think generally speaking, some women will tell you. What them know won't hurt them.
Suppose a man just come to your blade, you ask a man a question.
Are you cheating? Even another woman? The girl we had talked to her, I'm missing your phone. Are you not there? Yeah.
And
if,
him say,
if you should answer honestly.
And him said, may I do her, yes?
Deliver me. No. On second thought, me and if me want to hear certain truths, truly.
See, just as dry and plain as that, right? So all the other time, then you use a man, I said, boy, we want him to, man.
I don't
really want
to. It's hard to say me don't want the truth, and it's also hard to say I want the truth, because him just blatantly going answer me now, because I get
yes,
mad.
Yes, straight up. No.
I see this thing in his phone and I get mad. And all this man can tell me is, yeah, no, me I do her, yes. Can you imagine the anger?
No long thing. Oh, no grown, geez, no corner. Boy, mom's asking like a full question, blah, blah, blah.
I think it's all about how it's done, though, on a serious note. Because if you get caught, Mark, you get caught or, you know, caught in a situation where it's obvious that, no, man, this really, really look like so-and-so. And I come and I ask you. I think I would prefer to say, boy, well, mom, they don't say, I think they don't want for choice, you know, but whatever.
But what? No, more and more, whatever.
Subtly, it's all about you.
No.
You break it to me.
What's the whatever? What's the whatever?
Well, not going, you know, but
that's what you'd like to hear. It not going, you know.
Or if it's even a going. I mean, I know, just subtly tell me, man, but I come in my face, boy, yeah, me, I do her, yes.
No, I know, in your face, the man just tell her the nagging and him just.
Can't manage to blatant something. No, the face is something where you just give it to me, Cannot deal with it.
Make up your mind.
I'm trying to. But on a serious note.
So why? All right, let me ask the question. The answer, you ask the question, and the answer is not nagwan. Argument just
don't
dry
lie
like that.
To my man. Yeah, sure.
Yes.
That my youth, you mean Nagwan? That me I say.
No, but the argument done him. Done him. Tell that him gone about him business. Dry like that.
Can't just done so. Mm-mm.
No, but you keep a problem with yourself. Me don't tell you what is what. Right. Likewise, when you ask a question and the man say, yeah, me I do her, yes. Argument done.
So let me ask you a question down the road.
Mm.
On a very real talk level right now.
You know.
You buck up moms.
Yeah. You know,
and see the certain cast. Picture she sent to my you.
Yes. The usual flip the script.
Yeah, me have to flip the script on your mind. Usual flip guess the script. What? When we can't deal with certain things, when we can't deal with it.
You see, the usual flip the script.
So
usual flip
and that rude, and my listeners, them out there, yes, on a serious note. You see, in a mom's phone, coincidentally, because a big man thing, you know, search not one phone, yeah. A girl thing that I ended up on a girl thing, man, a big man, I search not girl phone. Mm. But you so happen to see. Yeah, I don't know how you see it, but you see it. The picture where she sent
to...
Yeah,
so the effeminate side, come on.
Yeah. you see the picture that she sent to the guy. It never looks so friendly. Just platonic.
No, hold on.
Or she not Brazilian.
Hold on, no, stop. Hold on, no. Kias, hold on. You don't even go no further. Stop right there. No. It's not. It don't have nothing to do with handling.
It's what?
Kias. Straight up. Because no. She never forget to that. Number one, where woman I send a man if I even want a selfie for?
No, okay.
In case?
Okay, so she includes.
Even that alone.
No, she includes. Eh? What's wrong with that?
Where
it's
I
our friend.
Our friend, how what? look for the profile pic and that's all him again.
Look here. She wants to give him a friendly picture to keep in his phone.
For what?
Profile picture is odd. Face set. Yeah, go have. So, hold on, let me ask some question on my
YouTube. Yeah, Cass, what the answer
there? You see.
Send a man one picture with him and mom's hug up.
You see the picture or a message.
Mm.
Hey, boo, what's up? You know, girls do that all the time. Nothing to it.
Mm.
Right? Hey, hon. Hey, baby. Hey, sweetie. Nothing to it.
Mm.
Nothing to it. What is it that you would definitely think off the bat? This woman don't call me sweetie. She never call me baby. Up here, UL, huh? All the time. But here she is referring to this man as sweetie and all these things.
Yeah.
What you going to think on a serious note, UL?
Nah, baby, nah, boy, nah, sweetie, that man.
Yes. So aren't you going to be feeling, and if you ask her, so tell me something, Karen, which man that you text about I sweetie and I baby? How would that? Not my friend Junior. Which friend Junior? You're going to say, okay, fine, our friend Junior. My social friend from school. Yeah, my friend from college. And I'm nothing. Big deal? Is it a big deal?
That's an old Dottie Junior. Dottie Junior.
Is it okay to just accept and she walk off? Oh, please, you want to know which Junior? Like, seriously, you're overreacting now. Go with a chill pill.
Hold on. At this stage in my life.
Whichever stage?
No. Hold on. When you grow up in a girl thing, that's different. At this stage, nope.
What do you mean, nope?
No, hold on. Certain category, I'm in a ramp.
She can't
have
no friend?
Certain category and things, you know, ramp at certain point in time. certain things you do before certain time. Because you know that certain time, the opportunity pass, you know.
Is there an era, a special time when you men accept certain things and there are times when you, special time when you don't?
No, when I accept it, none at all.
I don't get the time.
Well, I know. When I accept it, none at all.
Mm-hmm. However.
But there's a certain time for and a certain time against. Right.
Okay.
No. From a woman and a man, a date. Right. Uh-huh. When a woman just start talk and if she still, I wonder if you are the person, then she can weigh out her options. But when decides to say you're the person and she make you feel that way and reach that zone there, she can't play and a ramp prompt them thing there. And a ramp in time.
Is this her friend, her sweetie, her hun?
You don't know, boy, same way. I'm the same one I talk about. I'm the same one I talk about. More I know.
Hi, Gracie. Taria says, may I stop call cast on and sweetie? Kim, forgive me. Karen, may I stop answer to Putus? yes, Taria, because I appear Putus in car people, with you know. A pure Putus in car people. Wagwan Putus. Yes.
Wagwan Putus.
Charm says she need for know the truth. Me need for know the truth. Rashik in Toronto. Hey, Rashik. Good night, Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. She locked in.
Oh, go
right
on, Rashik.
On board. Big up yourself. Yakisha, Texas. Up team, she says. Alrighty.
Daddy will get defensive.
Yeah, man. Yes, Gracie. He gets defensive.
Hold on.
He gets defensive. Hold on, because
one must understand the difference between
men and women.
No. Defensive. Right? And owning your territory.
You don't own anybody except yourself.
Well, Anna, man, note what I'm saying. No? Your territory. And you know what's your territory?
No, tell me.
Your territory is the you in you.
Okay.
Now,
then.
When as a man, and even as a woman, right? When you know, say, you make certain, what I call it now, decision in your life as a result of what was presented to you. You see, all of that right there, sir, that was presented to you, you own that as a territory.
Oh.
You can never own the individual.
Mm-hmm.
But the feeling that it gives you, mm-hmm. that the person gives to you,
and
make it in that zone that make mm-hmm. you feel comfortable.
But if it's okay for you men to say, oh, we women must learn to share, why can't you learn to adjust and to share?
Who said
being called hold on.
No,
sweetie?
Who says that it's okay?
No. You men say to us indirectly and directly that we need to learn to share because
no love
jump on the case, but man short. So we women should learn to share because if we don't share, then some women will be without men. So I'm asking you now, why is it that it's not okay for her to share what she calls you with another man? Hun, sweetie. Hey, babe.
But you answered the question already.
No, I haven't answered the question.
Yes, you did.
Why so?
Oh, man, no shot.
We short.
Oh, man, no shot. Right?
We short.
So, as some kind of, what you call now, gluttony.
Really?
Yes.
But we do believe, with women are texting in, that men are better cheaters. And I believe that Charm said it. Yes, open Charm for me, please.
Why Yakisha? We don't trust why Yakisha, right? Or something. We don't trust.
Men are the better cheater. Mm-hmm. All of them are the same. Can a worm is only the label different.
Label different.
Oh, boy. Can I tell you? Let's see what Kim, not familiar with that name, All right, what is Kim saying? Or are we going to go to, yeah? Let's see what Kim says. Good night, Lady Cleo and Daddy Rule. Good night to you, too, and the
Silent Killer.
What? Lady Cleo, why Daddy Rule always want to do what he wants, but the lady cannot do it? Very excellent question, Kim. I'm meant to tell you, I have to deal with him every Monday night with him biasness.
No, I'm not saying...
You are saying it. Let's hear what Drake... Okay, Akeisha first, all right? I want the truth so I can make an informed, logical decision in choosing my side man. Bop, Miss Texas. You go, girl.
Hey.
Let's see what Drake says.
Akeisha. You know why I'm not around with them, because I think it's legal for a woman walking fire in Texas. So.
Yes, I heard that.
I'm not with you.
Oh, yes.
Not with you.
Drake. Hey, Mr. Drake. Where is Mrs. Jake? Woman, cheat, lie, and bad more than man.
Yeah.
Drake, you're lying.
Yeah, Drake.
To the skin of your teeth, you're lying.
Drake, 100% you are correct.
Why women always want to do what man do?
Exactly.
Why you men always want to do what what you don't want us to do?
Hold on up, my girl.
Why you men always want to do what you don't want us women to do? That should be your question,
understand.
Drake.
I don't understand what you say. You're puzzling me. What do you mean by that? Explain what you try to say to me.
What uno want do, uno no want we do. Why is it that uno want do certain things that we not supposed to do? That is my question.
You are mine, we?
It's for a man. That's a man's job.
No, hold on.
He can assist you, but that's a man's job to take care of his wife, his woman.
So hold on.
We'll assist you when you fall short. Hello.
So hold on. You know what, man? We ain't take care of we. But at the same time,
that's not the only thing that you men want to do that we can't do. Come on. I'm talking about
no.
things that you can't, want to enjoy.
Hold on. You can't do it, or you don't want to do it, or you don't think. You're supposed to do it for mine way. Take care of it. I'm not talking a little joke business and buy a little type of man birthday.
No, as a matter of fact, both people are to take care of each other, needless to say. When you're talking about being supportive, a man is supposed to look after his family. That's the overall.
What make you not want to work there? No. We don't want to work there again.
All of a sudden, listeners, the Bible speaks to the man being the head of the house. The Bible speaks to, according to them, from Solomon's time, that men had more than one wife
blah, blah, blah.
But here they are now, disregarding the part of the Bible, where the Bible says the man is the head of the house and he ought to take care of his family. Why are you all ignoring that part of it?
Hold on, Cass.
And jumping on Solomon this, Solomon that. What is the next king name? The kingdom name where they have the wife them. We want to talk about that all the time.
Yes.
But no, I omit this. Uno is
of
something
course,
else.
Of course, we don't have a problem.
We must talk about all the
things. We have a problem to take care of the family.
Men are supposed to be in charge then.
But what we are trying to say is, we don't want to work there again either. If we can't have no whole pa girl about the place, we don't want to work there either. So if you want to take care of family, take care of you and everything, you have to give up and make a whole heap of woman. How that part of the sound?
No, I'm not listening to you.
What?
May I read Tasha's message? Tasha in College Park, Georgia. Oh, my place. Tasha,
Georgia.
Welcome, honey, to Real Talk. It's her first time, she says. Cool, nice to have you on board. And she's laughing. I'm laughing, loving it. Well, we here at Styles Tonight, we're glad you're loving it. Cassidy and my co-host, Daddy Rude.
And the same number is our WhatsApp as well. So if you have WhatsApp, you can WhatsApp us on
all
that
right,
number.
Tasha, good to have you on board, girl.
Tasha. No, me never. My girlfriend, I did Sasha. I never
which,
Tasha.
Which girlfriend are you talking about? You're supposed to have my girlfriend.
You said my girlfriend, I did. Did.
Did. Make sure.
Yeah, man. Did, man.
Okay, because we can't call a guy honey and nothing like that. So nobody come call no girlfriend. You have a wife, full stop. No girlfriend around here. Okay. Good evening. In my opinion, women are better cheaters. Annie, why you say so? Tell us why. I'd love to hear from you, Annie. I want to know why you think so. Or is it a secret? Really, Cleo? Really want Drake? Oh, boy. I think Drake is going to be on my wrong... Well, I'm going to be on Drake's wrong side so tonight.
The thing about it, what I'm trying to get at, because my virgin asked me last week, and he said, Daddy Road, straight up, I'm confused, what do women really and truly want and expect from a man?
We don't want you to cheat. We don't want you to lie to us.
You want
be
a slave?
Faithful.
Go on, continue.
Be faithful. Be honorable. Men ought to honor
take
their women.
Take care of the house too. Take care of the house too.
Generally speaking,
take care of the family.
Yes. When I say take care of, I don't mean him alone supposed to be spending. You know, I'm talking about taking care of, ensuring that everybody's safe and their health is in, they're healthy and all that.
What is a safe? What you mean? What is a safe? What you mean?
Men ought to provide safety for women. Oh, you mean oh? Him can't hear a bang, bang, bang on the door and he won't go on the bed, go hide. Then and I want to push him forward.
No, we're not talking about the push forward part, but we're not smiling too. We can't frighten.
Be a man.
Be a man and what?
Be a man about it.
Yo, Cass, I beat
on
up
your
thing.
Helmet.
Cass, I beat up argument it. That. Yo, we're not depend where you depend. If I run business, I run business. Oh, I make you know that from now.
I don't want no coward in my life. You crazy? Hey,
look at that. Let me tell you something.
If a man will come in and I try to come out of the house, Cass, the man is supposed to be the one.
Cass,
where?
He better run and get a new girl. Let me tell you that.
First link from the night starts.
Turn up and dead.
No,
let me tell you that.
No, I agree that both of them should guard themselves and try to defend themselves, right? And their family and their children. But it's the man now.
The man now what?
Step forward and talk like Goliath.
Hey, Cass, let me give you.
Cass,
hold on, man.
Like David.
Cass,
still.
Hold on. Let me give you a real life story from to me at my workplace.
Oh, Jesus. Coward men.
Somehow. I don't know what that caused the whole heap of smoke. Something that burn. Right? I'm missing one bag of people I run. You know, they start cuss me. So how me just sit down in my office and then me start left out of the place. Me say, me tell you something. Me have a picnic in my yard, you know. Right? A witch, somebody you know, say run towards fire. Me run away from the fire. Right? And a search and rescue mission me there on the ass. And straight up me tell the castle. Me hear that? Eh? And I'm gonna get some resuscitation for us, by the way, ugly when we never told to one. You never see cats. Me I fool everybody I exit, me I exit too. Me say, let me tell you something, me never have no cape. Me never have no cape. But with a fire extinguisher and I run in a slow motion and dive towards the fire. Psh! What's it, man? Eh? Cass.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, me for run towards fire.
You're supposed to be a man.
Me not trained in that.
Bone to go and out the fire with an extinguisher.
At over yard. My yard. At my yard. Me not, look here, Cass. Don't make no woman beat you up.
Oh, Jesus.
But you run and make them to tell you say you're a wimp and you're a punk and you get a new woman. No matter with that.
Oh, my goodness. So you're telling me that if somebody were to say, try to break into your house, God forbid. What would you do? Put Karen to go in front? You're like a scraper on the side of the house and you wonder, wait, what that? This was at night, after 12? What that sound there? You know, I like, go to the window and like, you try to see what I want. You know, just in the bed, under the sheet, wrap up. A quiver in one corner, I pretty hard, your heart one, jump to your chest. And I ask Karen,
let me ask
go look
at question.
One of my girl. Go look at one of my girl.
You have a fight, war smart.
Mm-hmm.
You know, any matches and beer gun.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I can do?
Yes, I know.
Okay. Make him come in.
Okay. I hear you.
Right? That's a different thing.
It's a different thing.
Different thing.
I hear you. I hear you, Daddy Road.
Right.
I hear you.
So, people underneath you have certain and kind of weapon, whether legal or illegal, just make sure you have your name, your radar, your whatever, and one light to put on nearby. And anything
I like that.
Anything move.
Get scorched.
Just watch some dancehall music video and you know what to do
what
with it.
Do.
Simple as that.
Alright, R&B Barbershop in the UK says, we ladies, well, he says, you ladies accept the lie more than the truth. And women are better cheaters. How intriguing.
You know, me want to agree with the accept the lie better than the truth part. But me not so sure if accept it, them can't deal with neither the lie.
Some of the truth.
I'm confused, yeah, man. The bridge will ask me what you...
Hi, Kevin.
Me, I get confused, I know, too.
Kevin in Florida says, my woman mind me.
Yeah.
Give me everything and request me CM time.
What? Get off your wine. Right back on your wine.
Sure. Let's hear what Lisa says. Hi, Lisa. How are you? Welcome to the show, girl. And we start with...
Kim.
All right, let's see what Kim says and we go down the line, yeah? Lady Cleo, when the show done, we are going to carry Daddy Rule around one corner and deal with him. And if Cass agree with him, we are carry him too. That's right, sister. Endorsed 100%.
Oh, my goodness.
Me ready. Ready when you're ready. King says, be Superman.
Yeah, my
King. Love. King. That's right. Let's get the cape.
Yeah. Cass, me say, everybody a run away. Me say, me and a family little cube cleaner me done. And everybody a go and left me. Me if you run ground, they go find where them a run from. You idiot? You must be mad.
Lisa says, my ex used to stand in the bed beside me when frogs came. Oh, Jesus. Frogs came in the hole. Shake my head. Him should be getting rid of it.
Real paper
real soldier.
Lisa, look at her. You ever see a bullfrog ugly? All them up, you know, just have one bottle of salt.
I can tell you.
Nearby.
When I see the bullfrogs or the crabs, I go ballistic. Mm-hmm. And Winston makes fun of it by even bringing a crab sometimes. Want to bring the crab. When it's crab season, let's not bring the crab in the room to freak me out, literally. Who? You remember you asked a question some time ago. What is it that your partner does that you want to just like?
Yeah.
That's one of those
text
times. When,
and
yeah. When he brings a crab near to me. Mm-hmm. All right. This one from 7552 says, because it's harder to know when women are cheating. But once the man starts, we know without a doubt. Women keep things under control. But men change in behavior in what I see around me. Thank you, Annie. So much truth to that, for real. They can't keep it up. Even if they tell a lie, now when it comes off good, the other times around, you'll find that they tend to miss up. They can't remember what they had said before and what they told, the lie they told the woman before, so they can't maintain it.
Then suppose
women can maintain it.
Then suppose you ask a man.
For the most part.
Ask a man certain question, the man will simply answer and say, boy, mom, you know. Can't bother the lighting, or somebody asked me a question here, sir.
I'm gonna demand so much more right there, can I tell you?
So you demand the lighting. And when the man
there are certain
fellas,
that just
we have to have some we have to have some disclaimer argument now. You know? So from them side question here, say, look, don't hold me responsible for the words that I utter.
Can I tell you?
It's based on what you're asking me. And my instinctive responses.
But can I tell you, for some women, the non-responsive response or the non-response and the little blow it over response kind of gives her the feeling that he's lying. But then I don't think it pains as much. Because you have some men who you'll ask a question.
So what hurts them? What really hurts them?
They don't readily answer the question. They're like watching TV and you ask a question and you don't even hear a response. Because they're literally, conveniently blocking you out. Because they don't want to have to answer the question.
No, we just don't want an argument. That's what that's the main thing. We don't want an argument.
No, and then they don't know how to answer the question.
We don't want an argument.
Not only it, they know that if they
we know
the
how
question,
to answer truthfully, but we just don't want an argument.
So you don't answer truthfully or the answer at all?
We just don't want an argument.
So you don't do what? Answer the question?
No.
What?
We don't pay attention.
Oh.
We watch the TV.
I'm gonna cuff you.
You know, me never you hear something.
Oh Lord. Then he says, good night, family. Women don't want a mama's boy. No short. Really, 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 really. man.
But I feel
man
with car
around them house. Immature. Have no sense of responsibility.
You see how much things you want?
Can't pay in bills and don't have no sense.
You see that, Cass?
It's true, Denise. We don't want no idiot.
That's a lot of work to be a man. And then, you see the amount of work what we have to do?
We want what?
And then what we really get in return. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it is now 10 o'clock. We're going to a break. When we return, we're going to hit you with the Vox Pop. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, as well as Builders
Depot. Soon come.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for a presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Calling all bars, calling all bars.
This is an all points bulletin.
It feels so good to be back.
It does feel so good to be back. Hey, what we call it again?
Bar Roundup Volume 2.
Yep, it's the 2016-2017 edition. Bigger, better, better than before.
You know, Styles FM DJ, I got dead for shell down the bar round up them.
And a simple maths. You provide the bar, we provide the entertainment, the advertising, and intermediate updates of the night proceedings from the venue.
For bookings, call 286-9216 or 993-3358. You know what I mean?
You can't afford to miss this one. Ease.
Yes, I am up next.
Ladies, ladies, ladies. Something is on for you on a Tuesday night.
Smoothie.
No more loneliness. Now you have Prestige, your ultimate companion. Experience his musical charm with charismatic passion. So innovative and more interactive.
From 9 to 12 midnight.
On Styles FM. Smoothie with Prestige. Don't miss it.
Have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Be wowed on Wow Factor, Mondays and Tuesdays, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's informative, educating, and entertaining.
Wow! I feel good.
Put the joy of entertainment in your ears. Be a part of the Wow Factor on Styles FM.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Real Talk is back with you on Styles FM. Welcome back, guys. So we go to the Vox Pop for tonight. And later on, we continue to check out the WhatsApp messages, all right, and the text line. So here goes. As far as you know it, your partner has been faithful all this time. As far as you know it. What would you do if your partner tells you that he or she had fantasized being with someone else whilst having sex with you? Why would he tell me that? Do you think that's better than actually cheating?
That's the reason why, because you would have asked a question that's anybody out there? And him say to no, you know, moms, but you know, say Ray next door, instead of doing that thing there, go look her and thing, we just go and prayer and amaze when we do that something there, you know?
Deliver me. Let me read the vox pop again, because...
What's wrong with that?
As far as you know it, your partner has been faithful all this time. What would you do if your partner tells you that he or she has fantasized being with someone else whilst having sex with you? Do you think that's better than actually cheating?
Boy, Cleo, you know, so I love you in a putus, but guess what? No. Boy... You know, I see your sister.
What you say, what?
I see her.
No. No. Can you imagine how truthful he is being? Yeah. But I couldn't deal with it. To know that you're actually telling me the truth?
Yeah.
I couldn't deal with it.
Why?
I'm not lying.
So you know what?
Because I'm not going to say,
you want me to
oh, you feel fantasized about my sister, my youth. I'm a sister, that.
My girl, may I tell you the truth?
I'm a cousin, dad. I'm even a friend. Oh, you feel fantasized about my friend. You ever tell me, say, oh, boy, you know, say, boy, she have a nice little shape still in her. Just a picture and I imagine, say, boy, you know. I mean, which man I got dear? Dear, chum. Which man could I dear? Tell him, lady, that.
A man who is...
There are certain... A man who wants to die. There are certain truths you don't tell. If you even fantasize about somebody, maybe because, I don't know, your brain just wants to fantasize about our heart just happening in your sleep or in your dream or something, I don't know. You just not tell certain things because there are certain things that ever, which when it crosses my mind or if it ever does, I am not disclosing.
Why not?
There's a thing called... Right, personal, let me overemphasize, personal privacy, and then you probably have public privacy. That's a personal privacy. You keep that to yourself. Nobody ought to know that you were fantasizing about somebody else. Hell to the no.
While doing that.
While doing, of all the times while doing that, you are thinking about one next catty. You must be crazy. Then what you do? With me.
I mean, no, but remember, you know, you would be the vessel.
Hold on. Here we go. 7528 says, no, are the same thing as cheating. And if I'm a... and if him a treat me, him a go treat me, well, I'm not getting this part at all. And if I'm a threat, I guess, me a go threat... to call it a bun for bun. So I guess if he or she is doing it, the other party says, call it bun for bun. Interesting. Well, this one says, when the man treats you some way, and when they're not interested, they, I guess, pretty much stop doing things that they used to do. They don't call you as they would usually do.
No, sir. That couldn't fit in another category there.
Sean in Hartale is locked in. Hey, Sean, good night to you, all right?
We couldn't fall in another category because I really call more than so.
I don't know if I can say it's still cheating. It's mental cheating is different from physical cheating. Is it? Because you have cheat and you have cheat. Some people will tell you, I prefer if him dream about a girl, or dream about a girl, or if she dream about a guy, than to actually go do the actual act, commit the actual act. And can we so much control would all you, that goes on in our minds at times,
would
seriously?
You, all right, that revealed to you, would you... leave the person?
I'm gonna see him through different eyes. I'm not lying.
Why? Alright, then suppose is a one-off time him say that.
You can't tell me that. There's no way on earth him can convince me of that.
Wow, why not?
Because the moment him break.
But hold on. But
it's like an egg. once broken,
no, but hold on.
Cannot be unbroken.
Alright, you see the reason why asking certain questions where men probably rather to
lie,
avoid,
I can understand.
Or avoid answering.
And if because they do answer, one it's question, always going to be a lie.
One question are going to lead to another question, are going to lead to another question.
Let's see what Kevin in Florida says here, Cassidy. Kevin says, Daddy Rude, we don't tell women a lie. We tell women what they want to hear, that which is the same as a lie, Kevin. Sad to say.
So you want to hear a lie?
No, I didn't say that.
You want to be comforted.
I'm commenting based on what Kevin said.
You want to be comforted, right?
I'm going by what Kevin said. Drake says, so here, okay, let's open what Drake has to say first. Okay. If you're pre that person, you might as well cheat. The Bible say you sin in deed and thoughts, praise Jesus, brother. So here where you hear what you go your way. So Drake said, boy, once you pre the person, I cheat in that. So Kevin, is it the same way for you if you pre a sister-in? Or is only if Mrs. Drake pre a brethren? She for going our way because she's sinning in her thoughts. When you pre say, boy, yo, that be the hot in a star. But I take a piece, you know. When you pre that Drake, which a lot of men think that way, can I tell you? Is it okay? Or should you go your way too, brother?
Cleo, let me tell you something.
Fitzroy.
Cleo, hold on, let me tell you something. Because you're a hypocrite. You turn up a style since night, right?
Mm.
Listen, you are Cleo, you know, Cassidy. Listen what Cleo does, in. She turned up a style since night in our peak hat, right? Looking all gangster, but guess what now? She wear heels. What she expect? When I go see her, say, yo, bite all the bottom lip. They start drool like some real honey monster.
Oh, Jesus.
Start breathe heavy.
Did you just shake your head, Cassidy?
Hey, Cassidy, when Claire walk in, some honey monster just get up.
You see the idea?
And you can talk about, say, if a man say, when I'm about to say, yo, would I take a piece? The reason why man pray them way there?
You know, I think it was a male who created the heels.
Is what?
I think it's a male who created heels.
Me not sure, but it don't matter how he created, Uno still wearing it, right?
Oh, boy.
And it's to attract us.
No, it's not.
Then what then?
I already got you two in my hands, one on my left, one on my right. I don't need to attract you all again.
When
I already got you.
In
got
general, it's the reason why. And as a matter of fact, fine. Since you have way, what are you doing right now then? You know what? Come and be a foot. You can't come and be a foot.
Oh, Jesus, I'm always in flats.
You know what?
On a Monday night.
Run one of the box fuck them, yeah. So I'm
big up yourself, real talk for me. Well, I want a really sticky question on this. I doubt there is any logical answer to it. But, it's really up to you, you know. Because you might say it, I match up a relationship. And you might say it, and your partner just even more. You know what I mean? So, there's two ways about it. So, you have to really analyze and know who your partner is and what's about. And I personally, from a male perspective, don't think that a female should tell her man, say, oh, watch her. You know, so while me I get the knockings, me I think about the next man. That couldn't work out. You know what I mean? Fly high, fly low. You can't tell a man to anyone touch 30.
I would be pissed because me and him did have sex and then me and him say, well, whatever I am doing it good and we enjoy each other little moment and then all of a sudden him go tell me say, you know, say, well, me and have sex, me and think, well, palm patter. No, that wouldn't be nice for me a year. And then do you think that's better than actual cheating? No, I think it is the same as cheating because my cheating I mind. My day with somebody else, my thing say my have sex with somebody else, my fantasize having sex with someone else while me and him have sex. No, sir. I see it as the same. Cheating, cheating, cheating. Mind cheating, whatever cheating it won't be. But it not gonna be no different. It's the same.
That is crazy. It's sad. Everything that's wrong. Can you believe you're with someone and they're actually fantasizing about someone else? Oh, come on. I'm there enjoying myself and you're not thinking about me. You're actually thinking about someone else? Jeez, that is just not cool. That's not nice. My God, then that means I'm supposed to close my eyes and think about somebody else then. That the past cheating, man. That cheating same way, because not church, if you pastor say you can't commit fornication into your heart, although you're not actually with the person, but you're thinking about it, or that committing fornication in your heart. So, oh come on, of course, a cheating.
Fornication in your heart.
Welcome back, guys, to Real Talk. And okay.
Straight up.
God.
Straight up. Listen.
Just for people who might not know what we're talking about, let's just recap the vox pop for them. And it says pretty much, as far as you know it, your partner has been faithful all this time. What would you do if your partner tells you that he or she has fantasized about being with someone else whilst having sex with you? Do you think that's better than actually cheating? And so far people have said, no, it's the same thing.
Look here, Cass.
Yes.
No man never been no punk in a bed. Straight up.
What does being a punk in the bed mean?
Listen, you see, when you not perform, Cass, woman laugh off of you. More time, you go up on a mission and you're intimidated.
Bye.
So right away, you're going at the ring.
But you're already defeated.
You're going at the ring already feeling, say. You're not
lost.
Yeah. So right away, you know, say, certain potential we have now go.
But you're
redeem
a coward
itself.
Then. You're a cowardice.
Yeah, see, I left a fire. Left all alone tonight. What do you expect? Right? Yes, a one way can redeem yourself in the road, boy.
By fantasizing?
Oh, you mean? Pan sitting where I'll mash up all couple weeks or the holiday before us. So you start pray that.
I'm sure many men will agree with you that at times they've had to fantasize in order to reach a climax.
Talk it out. You never yet I do something. And if you think about all a different female.
I'm telling him enough night.
Can't see the look at the bottom of me.
Enough night, my work. You get me? I'm going to have to reach the ends there.
Simple.
And if you think about all Sharon and Paulette. You know what I mean? Jeez. Because I
and them get the vibes. The vibes are the right, yourself.
Yeah. And seriously. And I don't joke nothing. And not lately too, cause a long time I never do nothing. Trust me. Yeah. If I hear the talk, but are you buying up?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm buying up, you know. And I want you to see that, but I don't want my blood pressure go up.
Yeah, move. Yeah, pass through. All right, madam.
Pick up yourself, Mr. Smoozik. Oh boy.
Listen.
Truth be told, it's a real talk.
You can't go on some mission and left defeated. Listen. And one of the callers said, boy, you do your thing and then if you go know say your thing say you go on good and I really smart else. Listen, if the person
if the person
never did a pre smart else, maybe the performance on a bad stuff you enjoy yourself.
Exactly. So me no wanna know. Keep it to yourself.
You don't want to know why it's so enjoyable.
If you had to fantasize about Susan or Jane and not Cleo, don't tell me about it. Keep it to yourself. You're a secret, that.
More time.
I have a call online. Take the caller. Hello, caller. Good night. We lost you.
More time, y'all do all the thing and all the boys start week out.
So tell me something.
And the only way you can build back our vibes.
It's the fantasize. I have a caller on 954.
Yeah, like, that's all right. That's
yeah. Right, hello, caller. Good night.
Good night.
How are you, honey?
Not bad.
Good to have you on board.
Well, go on, charming.
Yes. Cleo.
Yes.
A man, I got think about one, then a woman. And when him and make love to me. Me no want him.
Me no want find out, my love.
Automatically, me tell me, say, when they get no good.
No, you know, I can't him no good, baby. I can't him serve. Anxiety, no. I kill him.
I mean, they are fantasized about the next person. No, so I mean, no, auntie, me better go pass somebody if I fantasize about me. Then we will just miss all up.
Well, you have a point. You have a point.
Yes. But me don't want in the family and fantasize about somebody else because guess what? I enjoy himself, I think when they enjoy but himself, you know, they think more just me when they write this up.
Well, honey, may I put it that way here? If him can fantasize about Susan and Jane or fantasize about Charm and make me enjoy myself, him can go and fantasize all he want. Once me having my fun, him lucky.
But you don't want to know?
Me don't want to know. Me just don't want to
know. Oh, me don't want to know, but me not going to feel good. Next thing, I'm going to say, oh, yes. Me feel good, yes.
But you what know. Me don't know, what me don't know now got hurt me right this a charm?
Well, me want to know the truth, you know, Cleo.
You want to know?
The truth. Me don't want no lie. Tell me the truth. If you, if, let me tell you, this is me. Even if me go hurt you, tell me the truth. Even if you have to beg pardon, tell me the truth. Me don't want the lie. Me can't take the lie.
Can't take the lie. Real talk.
No, me don't want to.
All right, darling. Okay. Real talk.
All right, charm. Hey.
Well,
you see, I like
why?
You. Hey, you know, say so you're easy for trick. It's like how, you know, we love the role-playing business and the dress-up business. And I said, boy, honey, you said tonight, your name is Charm.
If I call her online, Charm, big up yourself. If I call her on the 453. I'm hello, call her, good night.
Boy, good night. Boy, now I'm cracking up.
Well, that's good.
We can't manage it. You know, we love that topic. That's my type of topic.
Okay, good.
Later.
All right. Right.
But, on a serious note, UL,
yeah.
You know, I think more I know. You see, because guess what now? If he's not going to fantasize and give me a boring workout, me not in for that. No waste my time. No waste my energy. Don't have me there saying, oh my God, what on earth? What did I get myself into? What is this? What is he doing? This is wasting my time. I'm annoyed here. If he's going to have me saying that because he's not fantasizing, no. If he can fantasize and get to that place where I have all the fun in the world, then I don't know about it. I don't want to know what's in his mind. I don't want to read his mind. I don't want to know his story. Just get me to point Z, and I'm fine.
And that's it?
Yeah. Yeah.
So you know what? None at all know nothing like all the thing turn up. And when the man I said, boy, yo, Cleo.
If you make the mistake, I'm going to call Taria name. I'm going to call Charm name. Oh, judgment on him. No, make that mean, are you Keisha name? Are Denise? No, call, no, but just not call on name except Cleo name. Because I guess I know all hell broke loose upon him. Because I guess I know every energy gone, every nature dead, and him probably dead in the process.
There's one solution to that. One solution to that. It's like how mom's name Karen. I'll be a Karen me go there. So we can't go wrong.
But I have a question for the men out there. Cassidy.
No, what I flip no script, man. No, what I flip no script, man. That
no,
can't
no, no,
work,
no.
Man.
No, it has to work.
No, sir.
We have feelings Cass. Too. I want to know, 30th. Cassidy. No, it's not. I want to know, Cassidy.
Hey, nobody asks me that.
Is it okay?
Yes, you're not answering
either.
Is
it okay? And my gentleman friend was
listening. Turn on my movie, I go and watch.
Is it okay?
Hear what she has said.
If it is that you are so soft and boring and you're just tickling the lady, and the lady just remember that anaconda, that banana that she got some years ago, some months prior to you. Is it okay, gentlemen, for her to like remember and reflect on that granana that reached that place, that G, that little G, and gave her the time of her life?
Yes.
Is it okay for her to reminisce on that granana, UL, and reach that place
you hear she had dramatized.
No, I'm asking. Cassidy, wouldn't you feel better to know that she's there moaning and groaning? And you're feeling like, yes. And the more she moans and groans, you're just thrusting more and more and more. You're saying, yeah, man, may I reach to her, man? Yeah, man, may I reach that place? And you feel nice, like, yes, I'm a man. You feel strong and energized, and yeah, yeah, do something.
Yes.
But lo and behold, she fantasized about one bigger granana. Are you okay with that?
Yes, hold on.
Yes,
before I answer that.
You don't know. You don't know, can't hurt you. You think how you are all the goodness?
Yes.
You will. Answer my question. I'm going to
answer your question.
Well,
me go get
no, no, no. Is that yes or no? You okay with that, my youth?
If me not know, fine.
Aye. Oh, yes about that, my youth. Good for she good to go.
Yes.
Go and think about Drake. Because you're not going with nothing, my youth. And Drake did go with something sometime ago, my youth. So she have to reminisce upon Drake. For reach the place where she can make the nice for you. Think say yes, make her reach the place there. And feel like a man in yourself. Even though you're a coward.
Yes.
Who suffer for
her. I'm telling you something, Yes. What do you answer? That's why you know to make certain.
That's a true, Cleo. Thank you, Charm. Well,
Cass, you know to make certain you know your business, now, like Daddy Road, but I tell you the truth. Mr. Pong gas station, what do you? I got a beer. And me not the line because my car start overheat. So I'm going to buy some coolant.
Mm-hmm.
As me fe. Leave out of the gas, out of the that part where you buy things, the store part. Where your Bridging say, send me a box of Magnum. Bridging, I know normal people buy Magnum condom in a rude boy. Ah. Hey, abnormality, you know.
Oh, Lord.
So if all you know, say all your women are fantasizing with a Magnum Bridging, you're mad clear. Clear your own people dead and that. And she had dead, you know. Heart attack. I make you know. Some of them are weird. We're not going on the road with you. You tell Cass if you find a movie, make you watch some dance and not where you are. So,
let's see what Jake says. Jake said, no, it's not. But me keep it to myself. Cleo, you soon call him my name. Not a what's it, not Cleo. Okay, Drake, I'm glad you're admitting now. Confession good for the soul, Drake.
I'll clear the attack in the clear.
No, it can't work.
I'll clear the attack in the clear. I'll clear the bridge in the Magnum. The Magnum. I saw some big. I don't know, normal fit in a Magnum road, boy. I tell you that. Abnormality. Some Shrek.
Oh, Jesus.
I found that.
Goodness.
So, for me...
Back to Drake. Hold on there. Yes. Yes, for you. No, that one hit you. That one
yeah,
hit
man.
You.
You're that traumatized me. The granana. The this, the that. The her.
Oh, back to Drake. All right, please. I think I even got to Drake, too. Poor Drake. Cleo, I'm sorry. Did I read this one? But if me and Jody are kickback... A kick. Bad man come round. She better can run faster than me. I think I read this one. No? Did I?
No, you read it off air.
Off air. Okay. Daddy Rude, if you give woman the world, sell your soul. Sell out your soul.
Still
woman,
not care.
Still don't care. Daddy Rude, you're right if you hear fire.
You have all the right
for run. Someone must live to tell the story.
And I'd love to be that one.
If you're pre that person, you might as well cheat. I will read that part. The Bible says you're sinning deeds and thoughts. All right. I like how Drake's text messages changed. The tone of them changed as I gave the scenario just now. Yeah, I somehow think I traumatized Drake as well. Let's see what Lisa has to say. I did fantasize, but I never tell him. I don't blame my sister. It would mess up his old male ego. Can I tell you like I just did Daddy Rhodes? Yeah. I had to do it so he felt like he could turn on my pipe. It's true. At times, women have to do that too because I'm just not ready yet. But, you know... You don't feel like you're not doing nothing, so you just go and fantasize about somebody else.
So you're saying it's something that both of the sexes do?
Of course
do.
I think most of the sexes have to do it at times. And then there are times too. I've heard men admit that they're with a female and they were all excited to do it in the beginning. But then while they were there, they just weren't feeling. There was just some disconnect.
Yep.
And they had to just think about some other female that they enjoyed it with in order... to come. And right. I do believe that if the men are honest, that for those men out there who have had, who have gone out of their regular relationship with their girl or their wives, where they enjoy it, mark you, and for some reason they're gonna cheat on her, many times they would have to think of her with the other woman in order to come. Because they're mentally, psychologically, physically, emotionally, they're so attached to this female.
Which the female is the wife.
The wife or the one that they're living with. Yes. And in order to feel that feeling that they get with their regular girlfriend or wife, to feel that way with that other woman, they have to fantasize about the girlfriend. Order to feel, to even climax.
That collect too much trouble.
Exactly, too much trouble. There are some men who, will disconnect themselves altogether and just see it as a brand new food.
Yeah.
And it doesn't mash a works.
Yeah.
And then they go back to reality that, okay, I'm going to go home now and go back to my regular routine and just dismiss for the moment, yeah, that other girl.
Ladies and germs, this is now 10:30. We're going to a break. We'll soon forward. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And do remember that Builders Depot
is a sponsor.
They have special discount on for projects that are NHT financed. You must check them out. They are one of our sponsors. Likewise, it's Bayview Eco Resort and Spa.
Soon come, guys.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Babes, where are you over there, sir? Babes, where you really are you over there, sir, babes?
Me a look for the radio cause I saw schizophrenia with DJ Mookie. He have mad skills and crazy hype. And he's on this and every Tuesday and Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. No, me can't miss it. You mad?
Oh, hour. The hour between 3 to 4 is sponsored by Rap Auto Supplies.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Remember Styles FM on social media. View us on YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Follow us on Instagram at Styles FM. Like us on Twitter at Styles FM 961. Become a fan on Facebook, Styles FM 96.1.
We're back with you guys, naturally. Welcome back to Real Talk.
Tell them what you just said a while ago, Cleo. Tell them what you just said a while ago, Cleo. Why are you laughing?
This whole affair is absolutely crazy. Hey, oh, boy.
This is why I'm saying Facebook Live, nothing go on after
you,
Cassidy.
Boy, can I tell you?
All right, we're going to go to the Vox Pop.
Yep.
And then we'll start read some more WhatsApp. And then we have a lovely article. The women are going to love this one.
I guess Muda tell him, say, as long as I fantasize it, so if we keep it a fantasy and not a reality. I guess that's the only way me can look on it, you know, make no sense. Me get mad because man say fantasizing, they say actually do it. Do I think it's better than actually cheating? I don't know. Well, it's possible because a person really do not, the person just fantasize. It's a fantasy. It's not reality. So I guess if me have to choose fantasizing that the person is considered thinking of being with someone else while having sex with me, I think I would rather them fantasize that more than cheating. You see, my spouse love Halle Berry and always think about Halle Berry and everything is about Halle Berry. While me know, like my dark chocolate, Maurice Chestnut and Malik Yoba, so the way me look on it, you know, kind of fair balance. Him fantasize or him like theme person and me have my two with me like and go crazy over, so it fair balance out, but why me don't know that one at all. The way me look on it still, a fantasy and a reality, so it can't get away with that.
A lie, me would a cuss, I'm gonna go on bad. Is what I want to say. Yeah, man, would that just mush up on something like us. Something that really valuable, is it? And then go to the door and just laugh, because boy, do it, you know? Yeah, man. Think what a few other people mean while that's something that go on no more time, you know? So, yeah, man, but we can't make sure, you know, say, you know? Well, this course I'm going bad, but at the end of the day, but I say, you know, say, well, I just think you think about it and every act on it. But see if you have thoughts, act on it then, you know. But I think that better than actually cheating for you, eh? Yeah, man. Think it actually better than, but don't tell me. Don't tell me, say, I did. You see, if she tell me, say, she did, then a problem. But, you know, why do you think I'm doing for one and two, you know? Halle, you know, don't know.
Boy, that would be so devastating to me. That to me is even worse than cheating, because if you have been sex with me, I have to think about somebody else for us to have that sex. No, sir. I mean, I could have forgive him for that statement. I will always remember it, and even if I have a continuing relationship, because then you just don't get up and just left a man, so it's hard, and let something justice happen still. But no, Sammy, every time I see me, I think about it. And I think me could have maybe we're in a power in a left, because if you have to think about somebody else, you may have sex. Me can't deal with that. No, sir. No, go on to whoever you that think about when you have sex with me. Go on to them, because since that they make a issue, get that come, you go on to them. Me no want you.
This is a very ticklish issue for many people, for both sexes. Can I tell you?
You think it warrants breaking up with the person?
It's hard. I mean, it's hard to say you're gonna break up with them for that. But it's. But then again, you know, sex is an important part of any relationship.
But if you can forgive someone if them cheat and you literally cheat.
Yeah. But the thing is, you know, what it is that the cheating might stop, or then again, it might not. But while it is that you might think that, okay, it happened and it's done. Here it is that the person probably will be fantasizing.
No,
could
well,
be.
I your mother deal it now. And that if now, you're believing on me. Me can't tell you, say, you want to my girl. I fantasize about she, you know, a couple of times when me and I do that something, you know. But guess what, man, I left now.
Oh, Jesus.
That no can't work. Mm-mm. The man I left in my head. So why men I can't left in my brain? Men I did that in my brain. Why men I can't left in my brain? Explain
that. Is
that
how the brain works?
Yeah.
Okay, then I hear you.
So would you believe what I've said?
Hell no.
No, but
Shelly says all of them something there. If it is the sex. If it is that the sex not good, I'm not wasting my time with no fantasy. Unless it's my husband and we've been down for each other. Only way I wouldn't leave. But no fantasy, only memory. Thank you, Shirley. Shirley and I fantasy story.
I'd like to know what them star and asterisk mean.
You know one.
Shirley, and tell me what them they mean.
What? Let's see what Tarry says. Okay. Beep, 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 beep. I honestly believe everyone fantasizes at some time. I see nothing wrong with that as long as they don't try to change it from a fantasy land to reality land.
I darn sure would not tell my partner. Not try to kill no one ego. Endorsed, Taria. Not try to kill nobody ego. And trust me, all for them ego big already. Oh boy. Drake says, with all the faces covered. Cleo, big up my friend, Piggy. My dad would laugh, you know. You're not easy.
Well, go on, Piggy. Big up yourself,
big up
boy.
Yourself, Piggy. Cleo, I do have fantasy with some hot porn star.
Yeah.
Or hot movie girl.
Yeah.
Them just come in, Andy, when you're...
Drake, you know nothing about you.
Tongue off a ugly girl.
Yo!
Me not laughing at Drake, but just not laugh.
Yeah!
I know I see why you have to cover your face.
But she don't have to be ugly, but the reality is you do have them girls that where you know you're not gonna get. You can't get them.
6882.
Well, let me ask you. Would you feel better if it's like what Drake said, if it's a porn star, a superstar?
Of course.
Than your
definitely.
Neighbor?
Definitely. Fantasize about Halle Berry all you want. Gabriel Union, so Megan Good.
Why is
all
it,
of them.
So if you say your neighbor is more of a threat?
Than the
at girl?
She right across the zinc fence, my love.
Let me ask you a question. If you're, if Bossy comes and say, yo, the boy shots where someone saw come out and the brazier alone, because hang out close, I sat the morning time, the tongue them a morning time, boy, you have me weak. You don't go to worry about it. And you tell him to stop, look over there.
I stop, look over there. Now look out, now grow in there, now grow in the back. Stay on the front.
So, oh, I go watch out. We know whether or not the show on the back. Somebody have to look, you know. You have to look first, are you?
Boy. Really, very interesting. I'm not getting that part.
Very interesting.
Tristan. Really, Grace is very interesting. Let's see what the other WhatsApp messages are saying.
Oh, let me take out this.
Yes, in the meantime, between
because
time.
You are gonna love
Ken
this.
Says, I did it once, Lady Cleo, but I did not tell him because it's about someone he hates with his guts. That would kill him literally. Ooh,
no.
My goodness.
A wicked girl.
Let's see the other one. Mm-hmm. It was with his enemy. My God. Ooh, let's see what 1336 has to offer. I don't want to reveal my identity, no problem. I am listening to your program. I am an elder female. I found myself in that situation once. That was when I fell out of love with my husband. And that was the only way I could enjoy sex, by fantasizing, for I didn't have another lover. Do you think I was crazy?
Absolutely none at all.
Not, dear.
None at all.
Absolutely
200%
not.
Normal.
What I'd love to know, though, is if you ever had to fantasize while you were with your husband. Because she said she did it after. She fell out of love with him. But before you even fell out of love with him.
She said that's when she realized.
Now, hold on, let's see. I found myself in that situation once. That was when I fell out of love with my husband. And that was the only way I could enjoy sex.
Yeah, she grew out a love and in order for then that may I explain.
Yeah,
man.
But was it fantasizing with someone that you knew or was it a movie star, darling?
It no matter.
It makes a difference.
No matter. Then you can create your owner sitting like Avatar. So all right, she's typing.
Alright.
So after
let's
that
see
after
what
that
she
we're
says.
Gonna move to
R&B Barbershop quickly. While we come back to her quickly.
Yep.
R&B UK says,
I'm gonna keep it to yourself.
Keep that to myself. Definitely. Definitely. Not sharing that with nobody. And she says, still, okay. She was still with her husband. All right. And she had to be fantasizing.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you very much for your participation in the Vox Pop.
Mm-hmm. And, thank you guys so much.
Yep. And we're gonna go straight into the
article of the night.
Of the night. It's been a while we haven't been reading from lovepanky.com. So we're going to read lovepanky.com.
Yeah, I think one of my favorite sites.
Cleo will enjoy this one.
Tremendously. Tremendously, ladies. 18 ingenious.
Oh, it's ingenious, not indigenous.
Yeah, indigenous. Okay. Ingenious ways to catch a cheating partner. Ladies, you're twitching, right? Yeah, sit up in your seats. Whoop. If you're laying down, falling asleep, sit up, ladies. Sit up, sit up, sit up. Because they all are categorized in this category of cheating partner.
I told
you. And I hope Dan Dan's girl is listening.
I told you tonight is going to be. Yo.
Hey, Dan Dan.
But Dan, name of bother, make sure you dry out.
Okay, lovepanky.com. And this one is by Jessica Dawson. And who better to tell you than a woman? Who does your instinct tell you your lover is cheating on you? I'm having a headache. Instantly, if I'm going to read the topic. Use these 18 discreet ways on how to catch a cheating partner to catch them red-handed. Where are my ladies at? Sometimes you just know it. Right, ladies? You don't know how, but you feel it in your gut, down in your soul. And something tells you that your partner is cheating on you. Mark you, in all honesty, sometimes it can be paranoia too. But then again, it's based on your experience, right? You try confronting your partner about it, but they swat your concerns away and tell you that you're just being paranoid. Let me tell you.
Yeah, man.
Sometimes they are, not all the time. Ever been there? Charm say, oh, yeah, Cleo. Are you convinced that your spouse is cheating on you, women?
You're missing off Javine.
Even though you can't find any proof of it? Of course. Sometimes you may be going overboard with your paranoia. Especially if you're rather clingy and insecure to begin with. But for all my ladies who are not clingy and insecure, and you don't have no reason to go through no paranoia, but you just sense something deep in your gut, you're right. Most times you're right. But what if by some minuscule margin, very fine, your instinct do turn out to be right eventually? The fact that you doubt your partner is a sign that things aren't all rosy in romance land. And just suppressing your doubts and fears and pretending like everything's perfectly normal won't help you at all. In fact, it'll just tear both of you apart from the inside because there's no more truth in the relationship. Question, is your partner cheating on you? There are just two ways to get the nagging worrying out of your head. One, you talk about it with your lover and get a convincing answer from them. Good luck. Or secondly, you sneak around discreetly and try to get some proof of your partner's philandering ways, if any. And can I tell you, I have been called the FBI. If you feel insecure in a relationship, always talk to your partner and tell them what you feel. Sometimes it may just be a silly misunderstanding, and communication always helps sort things out, even if one of you is on the verge of looking out for an affair. If your doubts don't get erased even after the conversation, then perhaps the only way to get the real answer is by snooping around and looking for clues. Clues. When your partner is too busy doing their own thing.
Yeah.
Well, what's the next group name? You have FBI, And you have CIA.
Yep, MI5.
I'm told that nothing can get past me, which I don't believe. I mean, nobody bait me up like that, but I study some FBI thing sometimes. Yeah, man, if you keep on track, ladies.
No, sometimes I'm paranoid. You're too paranoid.
I'm business what you want, say. But paranoia, I look more me a FBI. And I shall forever remain FBI. Keep them on them P's and Q's at times. All right. 18 ingenious ways to catch a cheating partner. Confronting a serial cheater or a guiltless cheater never helps. Because no matter how much you cry or remind them how much you love them, they're just too selfish to think about anyone but themselves. So instead of confronting your lover every night, take it easy and let your partner assume that all is well and forgotten. Just let him down easy, yeah. After all, you can't catch a cheating lover when you're being cautious and on guard. Just pretend like everything is normal and watch how your partner behaves around you over the next few weeks. Real talk. Real talk. So here we go. Once your partner thinks you don't suspect them anymore, use these 18 signs, ladies,
yes,
and ways to catch a cheating partner to catch a lover in the act.
Me just learn the solution. Boom. A cat here text you. Cleo, kuya, kuya. It's a girl I want me, kuya. Look at the picture she has sent me, eh? I look at you that. Send him a message. Don't. Next time, no. Cleo, look at man. Look at him send me. Yeah? Look at you that fluxy girl.
Yeah, that's already, you know. she's the one to call me. What's she call me for? Eh? What's she call me for? I've gotten that.
It before. Worked? Did it work? At the time.
At the time.
Yo.
But ladies, listen and learn. Listen and learn, ladies. I want to tell you something. I have been innocently told to that. Me only show this person and I talk about this person as a disguise. When on a serious note and a real talk note, I did innocent star.
Oh.
Never hey. Have no interest in at all, you know.
Yes.
And I just try highlight, say, look, you know, that person, yeah, depend on a certain flex of my women, depend, but
I get caught off guard. One of the wickedest, idiot lie me ever tell. Straight up, I'm a fool lie. My girl, I feel like she have lesbian tendency, man. You me cool up with, pick nothing else out of the box.
Oh, poor you.
Nothing
oh,
going to pick out of the box, my youth. Me like, what the hell me just say a while ago? Just
well, ladies, let's see what those 18 things are. One, watch the signs. Do you see a change in your partner's behavior recently? Have they started working out, dressing better? Or started using a new seductive, intense evening perfume?
There's nothing wrong with that. That means that you know what it takes for the man, you know, make the man feel nice and good.
That'd be nice, yeah?
See, if you check yourself.
That'd be nice. They may have no reason for the changes, and almost always, these changes may seem very spontaneous. So watch the signs, ladies. Behavioral change, dress code change, difference in perfume, where we get it from, who buy it for him, and I buy it. It costs too much for even him. He can't never buy it for himself, and I buy it, and all these things, yeah? Start getting some depend phone more often than ever before, you know? And I'm going to talk to him, friend them. If I want to go out more often than before, no. Some signs them there. Yeah, signs. Yeah? Two says, drop by unannounced. Every now and then, drop by unannounced to their workplace or come back home early. Don't make it obvious that you're just spying on them. Instead, always have a great excuse to walk in unannounced. If your partner is cheating on you, the first thing they do, instead of welcoming you with a smile, is hide something or appear surprised or even angry. Trust me, ladies, when them get mad, say you show up, red flag. Yeah.
Where I do ya? Where I do ya?
So, I'm going to talk to you. What are you doing? What happened? What happened? No, I'm just coming look for you. Then I'm going to talk to you on the phone. You have to come and work with you. Come look for me. I'm just talk to you while I go. And you start to call hype top.
Of course.
Yeah. No, but watch out for that, ladies.
No, rude boys, once you see a woman a prowler like that, just left her.
You're lucky.
Argument done.
Some men get a thrill from it. You can't steal it. Number three, check their recycle bin. The garbage is a great place, Lord Jesus, ladies. The garbage is a great place to dispose of things. And sometimes it also has a lot of clues. If your partner is on the computer often, check the computer's recycle bin often. Chances are, there may be another person's photo or a little snippet of information that could be of some use.
But your top read is 11 o'clock here, sir. Inform us this year, read.
But I can't go so far, though. I can't go to the recycle bin story. I'm sorry. Me FBI thought other ways. Yeah. Like watch the signs. And unannounced, yeah, I've done it. 4, snoop on their phone. Boy, don't want them in the pan right now, neither, I know. Does your partner carry their cell phone with them wherever they go, even if it's a trip to the loo? If that's happening in your relationship, there's a good chance your partner is up to something. Take a peek into their cell phone when you get the chance, especially when they've put the phone on charge. And by the way, number 4 is not necessarily the view of Lady Cleo. I'm only reading from lovepanky.com. Okay. Erase phone logs. A password-protected phone, several calls to the same unknown number, or phone bills without detailed call information are all good signs that your partner is trying to hide some. On a very serious note, though, you know, as Winston would say, if a woman want cheat, there is not one earthly thing you can do to stop her from cheat. So it goes the other way around, too, ladies, quite seriously. But just in case you want the pointers, let me give you them still. Number 5, spontaneous sex. This works better if you're a girl and dating a guy. If your boyfriend or husband comes home late from an unexpected delay, try to have spontaneous sex with them when they get back home. True.
Why?
If your guy gets angry, pushes you away, or tries avoiding it all at all costs, chances are he may be exhausted down there. Bob, real talk. He could always wash himself up before getting home, but getting it up immediately and blowing a huge load, that's not the easiest thing to do because he already blew a big load. Where he's coming from.
Yeah, say, man,
that's a good one.
Say wounded.
Wounded. Can't stand strong. Only 2 legs standing.
Oh my god.
I love number 5. I think that's one of the best ones because
11 o'clock.
Take your time, 11 o'clock. Number 6, follow after a fight. Most cheating partners intentionally try to pick fights, slam the door and walk away because it makes a great excuse to slip out of the house and meet their adulterous lover. If your partner's been picking fights and walking out of the house often recently, try to follow them on the pretense of apologizing if they see you following them. I like that. 7, change your sleeping habits. If your partner's cheating on you, their sleeping habits may change almost overnight. They may stay up longer using the excuse of work, or you may catch them sneaking around the house late at night. Pretend like you're asleep as soon as you hit the bed and try to see if your partner's up to something. Do they get out of bed for long periods of time? And it's not just late nights you need to think about. Some cheating partners may even wake up really early and get on the phone, especially if they realize you suspect them. I mean, I know, but for some reason, Winston wakes up at 5 in the or 4:30 thereabout every morning.
Work.
And I know he goes to his
Work.
Devotional thing in the morning. I might check his. And for some reason, anytime I hear the phone, no matter how deep sleep I'm in, and mark you, I'm not suspecting him of anything. Not at this point anyway. But no matter how early it is, once I hear, you know that, because in the dead of the morning, you hear that. You hear almost every sound. I hear the phone keys, I'm up. No, I don't know his what. And like I said, there's no suspicion, no, you know, reason for whatever. But once we hear...
It's there, it's laying dormant.
It's, me don't know.
You know. Nobody come and come on, you know.
I don't let me be naive and say, oh, no, I don't know. I don't see any signs, but I ain't going to say, oh, no way. Crazy.
Hold on.
That's a man right there.
Let me do the time signal. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now 11 o'clock, and the time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa and Builders Depot. We're so forward. Yep.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Are you planning on doing construction or building repairs soon, or just simply in need of household items? Builders Depot, located at Bryan's Bay, Port Antonio, Jamaica, stocks building materials, electrical and plumbing supplies, paints, tools, plus household items to make your dream home a reality. And guess what? We have a special payment arrangement for overseas customers. Contact us at 876-715-3128 or 876-284-3337. Builders Depot. Once you need it, we have it. Builders Depot, a sponsor of Real Talk with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, Monday nights from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Are you sick of living an average life and tired of just getting by? Do you want to take your life to the next level? Learn the secrets of the super successful. Listen to Power in a Half Hour with Coach Mark this and every Wednesday night on Styles FM from 9 to 10 p.m. Learn the habits of the super successful and how to make these habits work for you. Learn to turn your dreams and desires into reality. You can win in the game of life. Let Coach Mark show you how. Every Wednesday night on Styles FM from 9 to 10 p.m.
Be wowed on Wow Factor. Mondays and Tuesdays, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's informative, educating, and entertaining.
Wow! I feel good.
Put the joy of entertainment in your ears. Be a part of the Wow Factor on Styles FM.
Good morning, Heavenly Father.
5 a.m., the Lord's Hour, on Styles FM 96.1 and 96.7. Tune in to be blessed and inspired by the Word of God and uplifting gospel music. Start your day right. Start it with the Lord's Hour.
And tell you what your sex is like. Yeah. I don't know what it is. I'm just feeling sex with you. It's like, damn. I don't even know what it's like. But let me try to explain.
When I wake up in the morning, smell that good old breakfast mama used to make.
Sex with you is like
the feeling that you get when all your friends surprise you on your birthday.
Sex with you is like
I made the last shot and everybody's screaming my name.
Sex with you is like
it's like my pocket's full of dough and I ain't worried about a damn thing.
When I think about your sex, nothing better comes to mind.
I wanna sex you all the damn time.
It's thinking about the sex. It's got me wanting you to come through
and do sex like we always do.
Sex with you.
gotta go looking in the streets, it's you. Ain't nothing better than the way we do. Girl, I'm loving having sex with you. It's like winning an award after working so damn hard. Sex with you is like when the man at the dealership hands over the keys to my new car. Sex with you is like when a check comes in the mail after being broke for so long. Sex with you is like it's like getting out the bed and shoulders there to take you home. When I think about your sex, girl, nothing better comes to mind. Oh, sex you all the damn time. Sex, girl.
I like that song, man. Whoo! Sex with you.
Yeah, yeah, Keisha, I agree with you. I stalk a business that straight up. Non talk. I agree with you 100%. May I listen to the thing and I say, how would I really feel comfortable with a woman where.
You don't have to know. You're not supposed to know.
Yeah, but
she must do our thing discreetly because I'm gonna need somebody's in her life.
But is it really worth it? Why not just left? If you have to go through all of that, the trouble, why not just go along with
your business? That's how you talk to. But some women prefer to find out the truth than to just walk away in doubt.
Man, I miss you enough in my life. You just go
I want to make an informed decision. You lucky.
I'm not responsible for any decision.
I ain't going to do all of this, mark you, but I'll be FBIing.
Me know you're not,
I shall be FBIing if I think I need to.
Me know you're not, I must
then
you want
me, I just cut and do my thing.
Me know you're not, I must you want me something.
Number 8. Does your partner want space? Space is something all of us need in a relationship, whether we accept it or not. Real talk. But has your partner started getting fiercely protective about their space recently? Do they hate answering questions about where they've been or what they've been up to? It's definitely a small warning sign. I'm not going to go through that either. Wait a day, blah, 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 every night, every day, I'm going to ask. No, 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 no. Because I don't want you to be asking me every time I step in where I was. Don't bother with that. So I won't do it. Number 9. They get jumpy. Try walking in or on your partner when they least expect it without announcing yourself. Especially if they've been by themselves for a while. Does your partner act jumpy or nervous when you walk in on them? Especially if they're over the phone or in front of their computer? They were probably doing something and they don't want you to know what it was.
Oh, the man's scared of you.
Number 10. And that's why, ladies, if you think you have to go through this route, it's best you're so discreet about it because this could very well just push the man further and further away. 10. Changes in schedule. All of a sudden, your partner may stay out a lot at nights on work, quote unquote, or have a lot to get-togethers on their social calendar with their friends, quote unquote. If your partner doesn't ever invite you with their friends, or if they claim to be very busy working and still look fresh and happy when they get home, your partner's probably operative word, up to something. Yeah, why would you keep on going out with your social, with your friends, and not inviting your girl at no point in time, or inviting your guy at no point in time? That don't look good. No, sir. What kind of friends them they saw? Well, me can't be a part of it at no point in time? Don't like the look of that, ladies. Number 11, the phone etiquette. Your partner suddenly needs a lot of space while talking over the phone. They either sound awkward or they walk away from you to the next room while talking over the phone with a few people. You may even find text messages from random numbers with random texts in them. Remember, when people cheat, They could always throw the other lover's number under another name and use code words, this is a common one, I think, to interact with each other when they miss each other. So there they have grandma or auntie Carmen and some names that sound like from elderly people. Like some big people in their life, in their family. And you see Auntie Sharon, or aunt so-and-so. No. They do it. They store some names there. And when you see the call coming in now, you believe, say, I want family member. I call them and it's not say go. Liar. Massa. Me tell you, it not. They do it.
Yeah.
They do it. Number 12.
How much more?
Gadgets. Not many. Bill, my youth. Bill. Your partner's changed most of their passwords, even if you thought you knew all of them. And even when you ask them for the new password, they make an excuse to hide it from you. And sometimes you may see that they position their computer facing away from you, and they would never do that before. All right? 13 says grooming habits. Hitting the gym, wearing new clothes and perfume are all signs your partner wants to look better. For who? But are they going overboard with their appearances? Has your partner started grooming themselves down there meticulously? All of a sudden, they start a shape after me, even though they aren't keen on doing something with you.
Oh my goodness!
So you're not going to go to that place with me. We're not going to eat first, second, third, fourth, or fifth, or whichever. Yeah? Base. But then all of a sudden, every now and again, you ensure, say, don't do your so well shaved. And you put a letter, and your letter, and your name. First letter, your name. Shave it out in that letter there. When lo and behold, the girl name could have very well been starting with the same letter as your name. Every time she go there and she see her, the C. Why would I say C? C is my name, Cleo, and Claudine. No, let me not use C, let me use H. So you shave all the H. Or the D, Van Deer. Eh? And you're not keen on going there with the lady, you know. But all of a sudden, one D gone there, or one H.
Well, let me ask you a question. Why you choose H?
You will.
You must be mad at burn up that. burn up. You know what? Burn up.
Number 14 says, sneaking away. Does your partner sneak out of the house every now and then using the silliest of excuses? Wait, a soap opera this. I'm driving down to the store to get something. My friends are catching up around the corner. I'm bored. I'm going for a drive or something along those lines. Well, here's the response. No worry, may I come? One by one ice cream on the road. Yeah, may I come with you? That's all right, though. But when you offer a tag along, what does your partner say? Do they make an excuse to go alone? That's fishy, don't you think? Never think.
Now,
go in a car. Now, go in a car. 14.
15.
15.
How much more?
Not many. Don't worry yourself. One bill.
I want to get into
now,
the
earlier
letter.
14 signs would definitely help you find out if your partner's cheating on you with someone else. But if you want to nail them, you're going to have to catch them in the act. And there's no way you can do that unless you walk in on your partner with the person they're cheating on with you. But if you do choose to go spy mode and use a few unethical ways, here are 4 ways to nail your partner. Cheating backside. No time. But try these ways only if you're already certain your partner's cheating on you. These steps are great to catch them. But if they aren't cheating on you and it was just a false alarm, your partner may feel extremely hurt by your actions. And quite frankly, might just left you. So be careful. 15, hidden cameras. Me mama. Place a spy cam in the room where your partner hangs out most often when they want time alone. And Cassidy's listening keenly to me tonight. If they're over the phone are doing something funny, business behind your back, you'll know soon enough. That's 15. 16. Create a fake profile. Create a fake profile and log on to the websites that promote cheating spouses and see if your partner's using one of them. Or for starters, just create a fake Facebook profile and add a lot of random friends to make your account seem legitimate. We don't have time for that. Seriously? And then send an invite to your partner and get friendly with them. That sounds like a nail on the head. And over a few days or weeks, start flirting with them and see how they respond to you. Are they interested in meeting or hooking up?
That's,
can you imagine who wanted that?
That? Look here, that's crap. That's entrapment. You lead on the person.
Yeah, that's
you
crazy.
You forgot prison.
17, second to last, key lodgers. Key lodgers are software that you can download off the net, some free and some at a price. For some of these key loggers, especially the paid versions, can be installed in a computer. Oh my goodness. And the person using it would never know it's running in the background. These programs can record whatever you want, the passwords they use, the letters they type, the pages they visit, or even record a video of the screen as they use the computer. My God, that's invasion of privacy. You can also download a few paid apps over your phone and install a secret app in your partner's phone to keep track of their calls too. 18th and last, it gets more spooky now. GPS device. This one is funny. Are you the one who wants to catch your partner red-handed? Then the stalker mode may work for you. Pick up this tiny GPS device that can be fixed to the underside of your partner's car. You can track their movements and pounce on them when their pants are around their necks or ankles. In a sleazy motel out of town. Use these 18 ways on how to catch a cheating partner, and there's no way a cheater can get away with their adulterous ways. But remember, don't use the last four ways unless you're certain that UL is cheating on you already and you just want to confront him in the act. And that was by Jessica Dawson.
Jessica, a wicked girl. Straight up.
There you have it, guys. I would
nice,
not
man.
Even...
Jessica look nice.
She looks nice, yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't even consider quarter
see,
of
a,
those.
They look a look at cause man for cheat. Them there.
Oh, Jessica, can I tell you? Oh, boy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was the
article. I liked it, though.
So we're pressed for time, but we have a really lovely no, you know, so nice, because you know, so nice, straight up. I mean, I like a good on,
really,
and more time sometimes some woman can go on some like a idiot thing. So here's what we're gonna be talking about tonight.
And I'll let it go. Is there real talk? Two or three, let me get that blown. Thank you, Cassidy. The real talk. 2 or 3 weeks ago, you did a show about a woman who found some incriminating texts in her man's phone. This is my story. My girlfriend's phone is always locked with password. But I never saw it as an issue because I believe everyone should have their privacy. Quite so. One Friday, I left my phone at work. So for the entire weekend, I felt stranded. I asked her for a call and she unlocked the phone and I dialed. A few seconds after, a WhatsApp message came in, and instinctively, for the split of a second, I totally forgot it wasn't my phone, and I retrieved the message. What I saw was the pic of a man's erected penis with caption, "Do you like?" Laugh out loud. The sender was one of her girlfriends.
Or so you think.
While I was stunned, I gave back the phone and said nothing. Being very curious, an hour later, I asked her for another call. and she seemed very impatient and annoyed, as if I was interrupting something. When I went in the phone, but I wanted a money. I'm calling big. When I went in the phone and retrieved the chat, my woman replied to the question. Impressive. Biting my lips.
Don't.
Woo! You want search? Take what you find. I then went further to look in the gallery and found pics of her vagina taken within the last half hour.
Mm-mm.
And a new chat with someone else requesting a kitty picture.
Mm-mm.
Kitty. Hmm. While it wasn't sent, it hurt me bad.
Shame.
Yes. I've gotten my fair share of pics from other women, so shut your mouth. But I never knew she was into those things based on how she behaves.
Yeah,
oh,
man.
Please, don't come that guilt trip.
Shame her.
Huh. It's like I don't know who she is anymore.
Mm-mm.
Where is he? Where is he from? As if she knows who he is anymore. I've been avoiding her for about a week and a half now. Even though she's been calling and sending me messages that I have woman.
Typical.
I asked her for a pic as a test and she get dark. Do you think I should tell her even though I searched her phone? I don't think y'all think she are going with.
Yeah. Long time for
that. Mama man think you are going to search the girl's phone. Give the girl her phone. Get a call. Make the call and give back the woman her phone. Whatever you want, find out, you look for, you find it. Deal with it, my youth. Go on, Bill. Hold that. That may not going to burn me out tonight, but I don't care. All right, so there you... no, Mark, you know, and I read that. No, but they always talk about phone thing, you know. The man, them bonus, the man, if you search them phone and blah, blah, blah. So... Well, it is that me not endorse the chick behavior still. But you better call my youth. When you come and talk about your instinctively answer phone and check message. Are you a phone? Do you get calls on this number? No. Check your phone. Gonna work for your phone when you left for work. I'm gonna check your phone and see which P picture coming for you. Yeah. You know, you don't search the girl phone. Hello, caller, good night. I done this. Hello, caller, good night on the 954.
Good night.
Good night.
Cleo.
Hi.
Hold on there.
Hi, Dan Dan.
I want to listen to Gary.
No.
Hold on, man. No, man. The letter not talking, no.
Repeat that.
The letter you read.
Uh-huh.
The real talk. No, man. It's so like this woman infatuated with woman things. It's like some lesbian thing I read, man.
No, because she saved the name under apparently on another female's name, which you men are so familiar in doing. You save another woman's name with another person's name as if it's your family member or something when you're just really trying to disguise her name. Well, similarly, apparently she disguised the man's name by using a female's name.
Then I was just so interested about our friend. She avoided our friend, and man, something sounds suspicious, real suspicious about the letter.
She is doing what?
No, man, something sounds real suspicious about that letter and her motives. What kind of motive she could have?
For what?
First of all, she borrowed a phone and she borrowed a phone to make a call. And
no,
she,
man.
No, you got it wrong. You got it wrong. The boyfriend borrowed the phone.
Oh?
It's the man who borrowed his girlfriend's phone, darling.
Is a man all right?
Yeah.
Yes, dear.
Sorry. Oh, make it. Okay.
No, that's how I said.
Are you right? Letter Dandan, you write it.
Okay. Anyway, it's the article I read about the ways of cheating, discovering cheating.
Yes. Yes, Dandan.
Yeah. That article, you know,
mm-hmm.
it's not for people who want to be in a relationship now. It's a people look for reasons for why I left a relationship.
Thank you very much, madam. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Because if I go through all the exercises for try and find out if you're a man or a woman that cheat, that doesn't mean the relationship.
No. I think you got it wrong there. I think the persons who would go through that is to actually really prove once and for all that they actually are. Not to find out if the person is cheating, but they already have their suspicions, they have their motive, and clearly they just want the ultimate proof, Dandan. That's the difference.
Okay. So clear. So once I get the proof, what am I going to do with it?
That's for them to decide afterwards. Because there are some people who prefer to be informed, and they make their decisions based on their information, their factual information, than to go off heresy or assumptions.
No, man. But if you all go through lens to find out if you're a man or cheat, it simply means that to me, you look for reasons to leave.
So Dandan.
You get the bad news. Just leave.
Dandan, if you're not cheating, darling, why would you worry what I want to do to find out if you're cheating?
No, man.
It shouldn't affect you. It should not affect you, Dandan. All you do is say to yourself, you know what? I am not cheating. And here's this woman going through all this stress. You know what? I can't deal with her. I got to move on. So you simply move on.
I didn't mention about spontaneous sex. Is it more sex spontaneous?
Not necessarily.
If
it is, what it was saying is, if it is that you decide to just have sex with him, which is, as you say, most times spontaneous, there are some people who, if they're cheating and they know that they just done let off and pop off one bag of juice, they can't get up again so easily the second time around. So if she knows that this is how her man operates and she makes that move towards him sexually and he does not respond to her, then she ought to understand, or she would probably say to herself, no man, this, I know my man and this is not him. If it is that he does not want to respond to me in a sexual way, then clearly chances are he must have gone through that process prior to now. So it's based on how a woman knows her partner.
Dandan.
Rude, is it?
Or it could have been that he doesn't find her attractive anymore.
So go along with your business.
Listen.
And fantasize about Jane with me. Go on with your business.
Tell that already, you know. Sometimes the best sex that woman gets, you know, is right after they get sex from somebody else, you know. Tell that already, you know. So you can go and think so. That's why most of these things are erroneous anyway.
Really?
Rubbish.
Yeah, man, changing schedule. People change schedule every day. People change routine. People change schedule. Different sleep habits. Sleep habits change. Them things change all the way.
Come on, we're talking about drastic changes, man. Come on, Dandan. I'm not talking about one and two nights you go to your bed a little bit later or you get up earlier. I'm talking about a regular change, drastic change in your pattern.
But you can't attach it to cheating. Why?
But you cannot. Dandan.
What's wrong by cheating then? You can't attach everything to cheating.
Dandan, and we can't detach everything from cheating. Dandan, we can't detach cheating from everything either, because sometimes it is related. They are related. And if you're an honest, faithful man, you'll agree that sometimes these things occur when you're cheating.
Come in with a diplomacy. Honest. If you're an honest, faithful man, I got rubbish that them are using.
Dandan, you have no worries, my dear, what she wants to do once you're faithful, darling.
All right, anyway, I'm going to pre-letter somewhere because I was misinterpreted.
All right, sir.
All right, cool.
I can know when Dandan is calling, can I tell you? Mm-hmm. I feel it in my gut. So, this letter is interesting. So here he is, this effeminate guy, takes his girl's phone, begs a call.
Oh my goodness.
I don't know how straight he is, to be honest. He begs a call on the phone because he left his phone at work. And then, a WhatsApp comes in.
Okay, you know, sometimes you have some phone where the message comes in and you just reveal the message same time.
Yeah, at the top of the thing. And if it's a long one, you won't see all of it. But if it's a short one where I can't hold on the top of the screen, you'll see all of it.
You see it.
Now, the phone, I don't know if it's a banger the girl have or is a real, real phone. Let me fix that. Bangers are real phones. So I don't know if it's a real phone she has or if it's a real, real phone that she has. But he saw the WhatsApp and instinctively him claims him fingertip just, oops, press the button to read it. And this effeminate dude read the woman's message on the woman's phone.
What makes him effeminate?
Am I the way girls do?
Which is what?
Search phones.
Oh, my goodness.
What he saw, he said, was a pic of a man's erect penis. And the caption was, "Do you like?" And I'm sure most women will tell you, I like real talk too, because we're on a break right now. It's 11:30. And the time is brought to us by VJ Printing Services. And Daddy Rude will finish the rest for me. Mm-hmm.
Yes. We're sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. And by Builders Depot.
Real talk returns on the flip side. Stick and stay.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
WAW, the Caravan of Love. What a Wednesday! This and every Wednesday from 9 a.m. until 1 on the p.m., Strongy takes you on a caravan of love songs. 4 hours of love songs on Stars FM, the People Station, 96.1, 96.7, www.stylzfm.com. Don't miss it. What a Wednesday, the Caravan of Love.
Portlanders, Acan Auto Technology, located at 33 Bomber Crescent, Port Antonio. Visit us for all your auto repair and servicing. We offer computerized wheel alignment, computerized wheel balancing, suspension checks, AC repair, inspection, and all your auto repair needs. For complete auto repair and service, visit or call Acan Auto Technology today at 715-5205. And remember, we are located at 33 Bonbro Crescent.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
If you're into me like how you're into your phone, everything alright. Me and a rapper and the girl, you're there in our phone all day and all night. But what you know, pick up this girl, yeah. Send me a bring her out on a date. Glad send me meet this a pretty Miss World, yeah. So I she me a think about sweet. Ask her some questions to get more acquainted. She not pay me no mind of such. When me peep over, take a look in at the phone. Me sister she a play Candy Crush. Me say alright, me a give her some time. Cause me sister say a move kinda shy. Me peep over again, take a look in at the phone. And sister say a WhatsApp a guy. Me know how she feel, say me a nine. So me not say nor do nothing wrong. Me peep over again, take a look in at the phone. And now she gone pan Instagram. I wish I was your phone, where you always in your hand. Always in your plan. I wish I was your phone, where you can't leave alone. Not even for a split second. I wish I was your phone, where you always ring in your head. Sleep beside you in your bed. I wish I was your phone, where you can't leave alone. Me woulda always in your
drive, na fiax her with this far. Cause every 5 minutes she take a picture. To home me seat at the phone, she a lift her. It a fi present like classroom register. And when me try to talk to her, she tell me stay put. She a check out her likes on the Facebook. Twitter updates from the site, yeah, she start look. It makes you walk out in the sun barefoot. Now she checking emails, what do this female? Cause all know me can't get her proper details. She gone tango, she all a Skype though. Look like everything the phone ya can do. I wish I was the phone where you always in your hand, always in your plan. I wish I was the phone where you can't leave alone, not even for a split second. I wish I was the phone where you always ring in your head.
I love that song, Keep Rich to the World. I like it. Reminds me of Tanya Stevens. Hey, what's up, caller?
What's your email address?
Hello?
I'm trying to email you something. Hello?
Yes, dear.
I'm trying to email it. Take me off the line, please. Don't.
Okay. All right, hang up.
What's your email? What's your email?
I just want to talk to you. All right, so you talk to our engineer, all right? All righty, so let's see what Drake says. You see, you're clear. Dandan, it gone. Can I tell you? Oh, why are you burning me out, Drake? Why are you burning me out, brother? All right. Let's see who else we have up there. I told you Drake would be burning me out tonight. Yeah. Yakisha says, why? Curiosity killed the cat. Which one of the cat? And she of course says the article was burn up stock or something them there. Indeed, indeed. All right, next up. Whew. Let's see what the text line has to offer right now. No. All right, Juki. Juke start, right? Yeah. Juke start. Big up yourself, Juke start. We see you, we see you, we see you. And he was responding to the fantasizing thing earlier. All right, so alrighty, so let's see who else we have up there. Cassidy on the WhatsApp line. Alrighty, let's see who else we have up. So up next on
so
the WhatsApp, and we have calls coming in like
so
crazy.
If you want to WhatsApp Daddy Road topic or anything, is 4395160. That's 876-439-5160.
Have a caller.
876-439-5160. Hello, caller. You're on air live.
Yes. I'm
how old is?
Yes, darling.
Me, I think you know, say me, did a man not left no phone. I think I free the woman, I depend on her phone regular in can the woman tell him, say.
Yes, and a phone not left my girl. Phone in my pocket, I hide somewhere, right?
Yes, yes, and I can't dream of the woman on her phone regular. In my free, I think, say, in can the woman, because she have a lock code for me. So I'm going to think I can use this to see what I want to do, man.
Hey.
But it worked, though. It worked, though.
They work for him, but me think that's where he go. That him do a general out this history and tell him both in the same phone. Can't want to see what she has in there.
But you know, if you say, are you there something she has going with?
Yeah, what she has going with that idiot thing, yes. But him shouldn't do it that way, you know, if you find out. Because he might have done the same thing and he know how did you be find out.
He no might, baby. Him say I do it to get film picture them regular too.
But how him will find out? I don't see no other way for him man find out. No must wait him though.
He don't need to find out nothing.
I mean, but look.
Well, if he might do it to where he need to find
exactly
out.
Exactly.
If he do what he might do. So I just threw my watch. I watch the panic phone every minute. And she said the last word, the panic.
Yeah.
So I do for do.
True. Real talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, chum. Listen.
Mama man think that.
No, sir. We can't agree with that. There's what other way the man can get information, but for investigate. I wanna just read it. I want the woman write, you know. I wanna
the
agree with that.
The only information I need to know is that him do it and he needs to stop.
He might doing things too.
Exactly.
Where am I though?
go and investigate the woman.
No, what charm? Where am I doing?
Don't drink thing. Listen, him say, all right, he left him phone, you know, I'll get her. When she call him now, she can't get him. Anyway, done, I've got my prayer ready, so I just move to it.
Simple.
What? What charm? Me not say nothing like that, man. Me say like the man. I go to you. Me say the man I don't
charm,
like that.
Charm, the man say, you know. Mm-hmm. Me get my pics mm-hmm. too, you know.
Listen to me. I no play on no card and no dance to it. So what kind of good youth? But the girl making you smart him.
Yes.
That she do. I guess what? Me now, if me know me have certain things in my phone, me ask him why number me a dial it to him, you know.
That's right. And as him say, okay, and don't talk that out of him and long time.
Thank you, please. In that, forget the police, my phone. True. If me know me have certain things in the behind, me I say, guess what? Yo, my youth, give me a number, let me dial it for you, you know. As in talk after that, me I get him back and put on back my lock code for him.
All right, cool. And ladies, well, right. You want to do like what some men all right, do?
All right, let me ask you a question. What's if you unlock phones? If it's a phone for lock?
Of course.
Everybody phone for lock?
Yeah, man, lock up your phone, man. Are you a phone?
Why?
Because of your phone?
No, but for argument's sake, the person have that kind of job or have that kind of interaction with people except you. Is it necessary for him to have a locked phone?
Well, if he not interact with nobody else, something wrong with him. He's an antisocial man.
All people have, like you have your photo gallery and so that have a lock code for it.
So what's wrong with putting, if you have private pictures in your phone, what's wrong with putting it in a kind of private vault?
But if you have private pictures in your phone, it can't be too private for your man.
But you don't know. I don't think people put locks on their phone just from their partners or for their partners, really. I mean, some people do that. But then I don't think the average person who has a lock on their phone is from their partner. I think it's for reasons such as a phone being lost or stolen. Because you have your phone in a market and it's your phone. You want to keep whatever in there. It's really up to you. But in the event that your phone goes lost or stolen, there's just some things you don't want people to be able to just openly see.
Right.
So I think that's basically why people lock their phones. And then sometimes children, their kids have their phones. And they really don't want their kids to see certain things that they have as for their private purpose or private use of their phones. So they lock the phones.
All right.
So there are multiple reasons why people do lock their phones.
You just style up the man as being effeminate. Why would you want to...
That's my opinion, dear.
I mean, I see what the man really had would I suggest...
It's only becoming of a man to take up his girl's phone and to be going through his phone.
Look at a foolish attack.
It's unbecoming.
If I want time, we take your mama and Miguel name.
It's unbecoming.
Right? If your fees are certain things are going on and always you can't get evidence.
You see, it's funny.
Well, you know what one of my brethren do. Me don't know how you do it, but road boys, if you don't know how to do it, this is what me telling you to do. You know, say, oh man, licky and then love phone. Right? All you need to do is buy a woman a phone and then do the backup business with the phone upon the cloud. So every little thing the little wicked woman a do, it a back up on the cloud. And that my virgin do, you know? And so the man knows him woman a cheat upon him, you know? Right? Every single thing him a ask her. And little dirty friend where she have to.
That is right? So mama
well, man. Well, man.
That's mama man.
Well, yes. The little dirty friend where she have. We have female friend too.
Mama man is right there. So.
The friend know everything we are going on, you know, and I encourage little crow relationship, you know. Right? So I hear that thing that. So if the man never outsmart she, we can print off everything, our conversation, and say, moms, explain this.
Oh boy!
Right now, should I not go in a rendezvous and everything with all this with this new woman where I enjoy him?
That rude. In the same way, you all think it's so bad for a woman to do those 18 things to a man. in the same breath that the man who thinks he has to search his one's phone is because he's so already entangled in the very same thing himself. Why he needs to sit down and tell lies him phone if I work and borrow one phone and go through the phone.
Yeah, it's a charm.
No, hey. He's up to no good. He's doing the very same thing that he's accusing her of doing. Mark you, she's guilty of it too.
What is he doing? What has he done?
He has also been sending his granada.
No,
to other women.
No. When I have nothing to say, hold on.
Stick a pin. Yeah. Bill.
Yeah.
Tell me, say.
Read the line.
Let me find it now, please.
We can't find it for you, know.
Yeah, man.
See that? Fear share. Yes, I've gotten my fear share.
Yes, I've gotten. Hold on, man. I've gotten my fair share of pics from other women.
Eh.
Pluralized. Woman, one. Yeah. Woman, more than one. So hold on now. You're going to tell me, say, the chick in girlfriend who I get granana, possibly, granana pictures in a fear phone.
Yeah.
And I send out.
Not a girl thing that.
Vagy pics.
Skettle
to
thing that.
To somebody else.
Yeah, man.
You're going to tell me, say, in the same breath when I get him vagy pics, him not send out no banana or granana pics to nobody else.
I'm not saying nothing worth saying, mother.
No, come on, man.
I'm not saying nothing worth saying that.
Let's reason this thing, man.
No, I'm not
going to. You're telling me that is why he is an effeminate man.
I'm not going to only receive
pictures and send out none. Is it that his thing is too small, it can't be sent out?
On a GQ magazine.
What do you mean him not send out no pictures?
On GQ magazine.
He has got to be sending out.
From your city thing.
Send out no picture.
From your city thing, you can't say a good youth.
If the pictures now go out, at least him have.
Well, at least him not send out none. But she know.
No.
Well,
if him have, this man send it go.
The man.
The man
said to her, say, yo, mom, send out a pic.
No, man.
Obviously, she pretend like a boy. She want like a good two shows preps. But I don't know, buddy.
On a serious note, I'm not endorsed for she depends still.
But what?
Big and serious. But I don't have no right to search the girl's phone. In the same way, no man, woman has a right to search the man's phone. But as she have suspicions or not, and she search him phone, she wrong too. But I'm equally wrong for take up the woman's phone and a search. Whatever you're looking for, brother, you have found it. Say amen and go to your bed. Bill and deal with it.
Hi, good night.
Good night, I thought it.
Hey.
Yes, I agree with you. I'm not going to send out picture. I'm not going to send it out if I'm thing good, you know. You can just take the what do you call it, picture them now. And, you know, I'm not lame business.
The man just a receive because the woman them just want to kind of lure
please.
Him.
Oh, please.
Yeah.
Me not say, alright, hear my problem with this, I know, Zane. The fact say, to all the woman, or when I say the woman portray herself to be this kind of nice girl and all kind of stuff, it shock him, you know. Because probably if a man didn't know, say, well, alright, when he requests a photo from the woman, he might get it. But it says something, you know, when we always talk about, you know, say, enough of the time, you're in a relationship. And depending on how the relationship is structured, especially from the inception, certainly go freaky sitting about your partner, you know, you know. A little old kuru like me now will dry out her. You know what I'm saying?
True.
Where's it, Tara?
True.
Put your mouth on your phone, man, and take whatever else with your mouth from this when you attack with daddy.
True.
Where are those? You're true.
I shoot your talk.
Okay. You're terrible.
I agree with you, Daddy. Dry out of them.
Simple. Hey.
So, Tero.
Hold on. Tero, my message is something. What are going on about foreign? You protest too?
No, sir. I'm not protest.
What make?
I'm not protest. I wait.
Yeah.
Wait to see what I'm going to do.
Like what, sir? You have to go to Russia. That may make you know.
Like build a wall.
Russia. After Russia, no know better than over here. Then I see him hot water.
You're going to help build the wall, Tero?
Billboard?
Yes.
How oh, can Billboard tell when a Mexican can go through? Mexican build tunnel. They put up a wall, Mexican say, what? No walk under that.
Under that. Can I tell you, he's going to have to employ the same Mexicans to build those walls because the Americans, some of them ain't taking those jobs.
So, that's so true.
So tell me something. You know, I'm going to understand all this popularity voting versus
yes.
the other thing. How that go? You know where it go?
The electorate chooses the president, they say.
What is electorate?
So them have like a certain number of delegates for each state.
Yes.
And those delegates decide from each state who they want to be the president.
So are the delegates, they want Trump and the people, they want
Hillary.
Hillary.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh.
Yep. Messed up, eh?
Yeah, it is. So could we safely say then that most of those delegates are Republicans?
Lord, my child, don't you see it? Or maybe them even get buyouts too.
Okay.
Or is it that the whole, what do I call it now, double standard with females that they don't want a female
I think so.
President?
And that too?
I think that's the
that
case. Too? Yeah, I strongly think that's the case. When they take a black man in power, a female ain't going to get there so easily.
Yeah, because even Hillary never go against Obama and Obama wins. So it's like them don't want a woman.
Yeah, I think that's predominantly the reason, to be honest.
Yeah.
Because she hasn't done...
One woman runs the presidency, you know, she's the second one.
Yeah. She hasn't done anything worse than what Trump has done. And if you were to look at it from that standpoint, then she'll be in a better stance than he is, in my opinion. So I think it's because of the sex issue, the gender issue. Yep.
Gender issue.
Yep.
Hey, Tara. You remember a little man that I tell you about when I say I have a yard for you?
Where you say what?
Remember a man that I tell you about when I tell you I have a yard for you?
Yeah.
I him do the sitting with the cloud, you know?
Oh yeah, I say.
Bad
move, that. It's a bad move. It's a bad move.
You like the idea?
Everything. You find out everything you want to find out, eh?
Everything you want to find out. I'm like a girl too, you see?
Uh-uh.
I like her, man. I encourage them to stay together, man.
Are you encouraging them to stay together after that?
Oh, you mean?
You're a wicked man.
Yo, Tara, later.
All
right, darling.
All right.
Oh, boy. Can I tell you, we're coming down to the wire, guys. The question is asked, do you think I should tell her? I asked her for a picky, says.
Yeah, because,
like a test.
Because obviously she had gone and said she had this all, this nice old, you know. I don't see her as me. I say. Me nah say she can't have her little game of play, no. Cause that no means a boy she had done
she's
nothing.
She's doing anything, right?
Right. She can probably enjoy her little self, just like
a flirting
with,
around.
With, yeah, with no one in with her life, forget her one little pick, no one then, right? But at the same time, if your man a request,
yeah, that's what me can't get.
Me no see why you can't send it a road.
Yeah, real
and,
talk.
And you can't make the thing go on when the man there work and want something.
Real talk.
Because again, to the man, might as well get a pick them and a request pick them because him not get none from you.
Whatever, that rude. Whatever. No. That ain't gonna work. Bring that up for me, please.
No, but
yeah, a little bit up. Should I tell? Okay, that's it. Should I tell her? No, there's a piece at the bottom. Do you think I should tell her? Tell her what? That he sees the pictures?
Yeah, she need to stop acting as if so she's this
whatever, because here I am. I know what you're doing.
Right.
I'm on to you.
And then she might go deny it, and the only way him can know. You know what he should have done? Him should have WhatsApp the picture of them to himself, and then delete out fear sent to him.
You sound like you're part of the 18 thing right there.
Well, me neither listen what you say.
Send them to him himself.
Yeah.
Then delete what he sent to her.
Delete it so she can know him sent it.
So how else would he have gotten it them?
How else would he have gotten them?
Yes.
If no, he didn't send them. At the time, you know why she suspects you're running upon the thing, your FBI out the thing.
So I think. The reason why he's contemplating if he should tell her or not is because of what the end result might be.
Like what, sir?
Because if she knows, possibly, if she knows that this man has been going through her phone, it might just be a bangarang.
It's a boy, my mama man.
Mama man ting and cuss him out and probably just walk away, depending on how close and tight they are anyways. Because there are some women who will not. There are some women that I know, if a man shows any sign of effeminate behavior, believe me, she just, ew.
No, what? Scoffs
at him.
Not effeminate about the man. I check out certain things.
I mean, I like the idea of him just go through the phone. I mean, I know. I just feel like an own fear.
No, but why?
And I send. It's just weird.
Listen, you borrow your man phone, and you saw a big old sitting. I bought up right away because my man on the phone today and ears at the time too. You know when I pick the come in, you know. Hey, Cass, the phone there, the man ears. When the big old girl and I roll in for the ears.
Oh my God.
Yo, you can't blame the man for the way, though. I hear that thing that one.
Online. Hello, caller.
Yeah, clear. You know, so if the man revealed to him, girl, when see, she just left him instantly, you know.
Yeah?
Yeah, man. So if him want her to leave, yeah, reveal to her. Because every man, most man, I go on privacy in a film phone, and if him go broke the privacy protocol on him girl phone, the girl can't respect him again.
Quite so.
But Dan, remember the one where we talked about a couple of weeks ago, you know, where apparently there's a choice between his sister and her boyfriend, but for someone she just had to be the woman, something lower her fee. If he's going at the man phone.
Yeah, all right, yeah. Him get lured. Not trying to get lured.
Because remember, you know, the man's intention, you know, obviously wasn't to go in the phone, you know. The man's intention was to make a call.
Lie.
Right?
Lie.
And then now.
All the more reason then.
While getting the call, a little violation going on his cars. To that the erected sitting the way I'm talking about.
Lie.
He must feel all the phone jump on his ears.
Dan.
You see me?
Him did suspect something long time and him want a reason to search the phone.
No, sir. The man said shocked.
Right. That's a possibility.
The man shocked in disbelief.
Well, that's what I was saying. If you have a suspicion and you feel the need for search, just leave. Just leave.
Me agree with that one there.
So if you just leave, then I stop searching the man's phone, right?
No.
No. You just say, if you have a suspicion, if you need to search.
If you want to leave, tell her, and then walk away.
No.
If you want to protect the relationship, don't mention it.
Stick up in.
Because, look here. Now I ask you, Cleo.
Hold on, man.
Respect for your man after him admit to you, say him going to your phone and sue him. You got respect for him like that?
No, not necessarily. But that's not the point we're making.
No, the same thing.
Dan, I'm going by your statement. If you have a need to search and to do all this investigation, just leave. So my question to you, my friend, is, since the man have a need to search the woman's phone, how about just leaving her alone? Just leave.
But remember, it's
a double standard talk. I can't be done clear.
Him claims that he accidentally stumbled upon it. You know?
Lie. Accidentally what?
No, I believe a lie too. Because man program where it's automatic. Them the pass money for and things after them for man program
women do those things. Women will just say, okay, it's his phone, but a message came in, I'm want to see what one. A woman just intuitively just touch that on a business, but a man do it, oh please.
This is true. But let's him let's give him the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah.
If it is that he wants to remain in a relationship, him don't mention it to her.
Him just bill.
Answer why?
Yes, bill and take a taste of his own medicine.
Yes.
Right. Yes. Could you handle it though, Dan?
Dan, I'm kind of lose her thing, but I'll go.
Dan, could you handle it, darling?
No, that thing I wouldn't face me.
Oh, really? You see a big granana bigger than yours in your woman's phone?
Why should that picture face me?
Oh, you don't know if she's getting that picture.
No, well, them say why you don't want to hurt you, so.
You wouldn't want to find out?
I just comment on the article, the 18 reasons you read a while ago.
If you see the picture on the human phone, you wouldn't want to ask her who that?
Hold on, all right. If, suppose I ask, and she tell me, say.
You can't answer me question with a question, Dan. You wouldn't want to know who that.
Suppose I ask, and she tell me, say, you will. What am I going to do with that information?
You're going to ask her is who that?
No. Is that what I ask? What you just ask me?
Would you ask her is who that?
No, but that's what I'm asking you now. If I were to ask her that question, what would I do with that information? How would that information benefit me?
I would answer your question if you would ask her.
No, I wouldn't ask her. Because,
you would ask her. I like you, Dana. I like you bad. You know, I make that fizzle. No time, my you. I like that. Real talk.
But Dan, we're going to wrap up shortly here. Your respect.
Thank you, Dan. Dan is playing it politically correct on me tonight.
Look here, no? Straight up. I'm not busy with that man who want to go to the
then
phone.
Then I go ask her, where is it the granana bigger than Fimo?
Yo, a straight violation.
Oh, boy.
When the woman knows that the man is on the base and she gets certain messages and them thing there. All of that have to stop and ease off.
Well, if he sees no sign of her cheating and treating him any differently or worse off, leave it alone. She's doing it. If you can handle
like, it look like
just he can't stay. Not try nothing at all. Leave it alone.
It look like Adesso him want to leave it because him not mention nothing about suspicion of her cheating.
Exactly. So
Adesso a photo thing.
Him just begs.
Him
just begs.
It's a violation. But
it's amazing how men can't take anything that they give.
So what's the issue?
Oh, please.
Something wrong with that?
Learn if you can't take one of the shout, give away.
Burn up. Burn up. You know, do the sign out here, sir. Road boy, as far as
ladies.
Me say, yeah, me as say road boy, talk to the big woman and say, yo, moms. You know, say more time. As I'm, hey, let me tell you something, Medan. You need to make sure you say, what go on in a fear phone? So she not have nothing over you. Make sure you say, where you are get a road. Say, so, all right, moms. Me not get it from you, but this is what I go on, so I just saw the thing set. Just level it right there, so. Don't make sure you know, so you know what she are doing. And give him about one next 2 to 3 months. Give him 2 to 3 months. And anytime you get a pic, you make him know so you get it. Simple
my
as that.
Youth, if what you get on your picture, the picture.
Not enough fear bun you.
If the pictures them my youth no better than fear on them, don't send them to her.
No, not do that. No. Not do that. You can't make sure you have to make sure fret. No, not do that. You have to make some woman send some terrible picture.
And if they don't look better than hers, don't send them.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
You have to send something proper. You have to make sure you see some proper something. Even if you have to go on a little porn site and take a picture yourself.
A liar.
Take a picture yourself. That me, I tell you. You have to flap our show. Straight up.
Jesus, that,
flap our
so,
show.
That might not be so easy.
Simple.
Anyways, guys, we're out of time and, you know, another crazy show with my crazy co-host and getting their crazy engineer tonight. I don't know how I'm going to survive with all this madness around me, but I'll do my best. Until next week, guys, on behalf of Cassidy, our engineer, and my co-host, this is Lady Cleo saying, hey, give what it is that you want to receive for yourselves in your relationship. Until next week, I'm going to say thanks to all our listeners, all those who called in, all those who texted in, all our friends on the World Wide Web who were in tune with us tonight. And until next week, let me big up my dog. Big up my dog, Roof, 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 Pitbull, who takes care of me every Monday night. Take me to and from work. Pick up yourself, my dog. And please be here on time, like right now. Yeah.
I want to make an announcement. Do remember that we have some Styles FM shirts going. And there are some brand new shirts, new prints, etc. And them really going. So just make a link up so we can get some new stock ASAP, like all them one of those forward. You know, different ones we have now, so you'll see them. Who have on my WhatsApp, you can see them and just make your order.
I saw those and I want to get in.
Yeah, man. Them into nice. One of those. The material, them feel good, everything. Yeah. Nice. So what you ever say, so me can so me for say.
Until next week, guys. Lady Cleo, love you all so much. All the guys out there, all the girls, big up yourselves. And until next week, Daddy Rude tells us.
Big up my wife for life.
Bye, y'all.
Outer Road.